Patriarch of the DeKinmy family, happy birthday to Ms. Anita DeKinmy. And to the Wolf Man himself, John Clay Wolfe. Everyone from the bingo hall says to remember that 51 is the new 20. You old.
Hit him up now, 800-800-RADIO, or log on to GoWolf.com.
Did y'all hear Jimmy Buffett died?
That's why we're playing this song.
Oh,
Jimmy passed away peacefully on the night of September the 1st, surrounded by family, friends, music, and dogs. He lived his life like a song till the very last breath and will be missed beyond measure.
What did he die of?
They haven't said that yet. In May, they canceled a bunch of shows. They pulled him off the road, did some tests, but he's been photographed since then. Looking fine. So whatever it was, they didn't want to talk about it. But clearly they knew it was coming if he was surrounded by friends and dogs and everybody.
Well, friends and pets and dogs.
That's the way you live, babe. That's the way you die.
We had audio a few weeks ago. He came out and jammed with his friend Mac McAnally.
Yeah, Mac.
For a live show in Mobile, I think. That's a big one, JJ.
What age?
That's a big one, man. 76.
Kind of young.
Very kind of young.
My neighbor bought his airplane. Did I ever tell you that?
No.
Yep.
Which one?
Falcon.
The Falcon.
Falcon.
The three-holer.
Yes. Falcon. Not a 900, but
wow.
Anyway. 50.
50.
Yeah, Falcon.
Now, it's time for Plane Talk with your captain, J.D. Ryan.
Yeah, that's wild. That's wild. No, I did not know that.
He's dead. Jimmy Buffett.
Jimmy Buffett
is dead.
What a full life he led.
God, no kidding.
I mean,
he got cut a little short at 76.
Yeah, he did. He's wasted away in Margaritaville now, for real.
Mm-hmm.
But he banged his head on the wall of country music for decades and never really got in. Mm. He and Steve Earle and Lyle Lovett never got in. But Jimmy surpassed that. He was an author. He was a pilot, as you said.
He's an alcoholic.
We don't know.
Probably.
I'm not asking you for verification. I'm making an observation.
You make it sound negative.
Well, I mean, absolutely. I mean, he promoted alcoholism, and a lot of people. Cheers to Jimmy Buffett. Not that I'm promoting alcoholism, but if you are an alcoholic and you're up this morning drinking, Danny. Get your blender going.
Not a Reggie Youngin, slip sliding, commode hugging drunk, but God's own drunk and a fearless man.
He was in Hawaii surfing like 2 months ago.
Really?
Yes. Yes. Very healthy guy, man. Swimming, surfing all the time. Sailing.
How old are you, JD?
66.
No, 10 years away from dying.
I know. You're not.
Ten years away from dying.
Come on.
I'm 10.
God almighty,
so everybody dies at 76, John? Everybody?
Are you 66 for real?
John's got this thing about numbers since he turned 51 and death. It's coming for him.
I'm going to die at 60.
Quit saying that.
Will
I
you
knew
stop?
Somebody else.
I don't know.
No.
We're going to lock you up at 59 and not let you out.
Dear Lord.
Lock me up at 69 between the thighs.
Nah.
Hey, you're an idiot.
800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO.
It's been a lovely cruise.
If you have your best Jimmy Buffett story, call in. We'll share it. We are in Florida right now in the Keys, so
indeed.
It's Jimmy Buffett kind of place.
All the blenders are silent.
All the blenders are... God almighty, JD.
Jeezy.
All the blenders are... Everyone today, over this weekend...
Right.
Please don't use your blender in honor of Jimmy Buffett.
We hope American singer and songwriter James Buffett finally found his lost shaker of salt.
Yeah. That's right, that idolized shaker of salt. It's his own damn fault.
Such great lyrics, man. I picked up Buffett in a big way when I was in country radio, when I was still a teenager, and I didn't find the music palatable all the time. So artists like the Bellamy Brothers and Jimmy Buffett made it a hell of a lot easier for me to hang around.
He didn't like radio people at all because radio never embraced him. Yeah, ever.
Why?
Because he didn't fit. He didn't fit in country. He didn't really fit in rock or pop. He was just kind of in the middle, so he made his own way rather well.
Listen to this one. I just thought about this.
Getting out to San Francisco. For the Labor Day weekend show.
He is not heading out this weekend.
No, he's already there.
He's straight, isn't he?
Very.
He head out for real.
Very straight.
You didn't get my joke.
I didn't get it.
San Francisco.
Oh, I get it. Ah, took me a second.
You people need to warm up.
Does anybody want to?
Us people.
You people.
Does anybody want to guess what Jimmy Buffett's net worth might have been?
More than mine.
$400 million.
I would say $5 million. $500 million.
I'm going to say $7 billion.
$7 billion.
$7 billion.
I don't think. I think it's a bit high there, Bob.
Well, let me ask you something. How much did he take with him?
None. Good point. Mm.
Just the salt.
Yeah.
So what's the answer, Bob? Do you know?
He doesn't know. He's just talking.
$1 billion.
B is a billion. $1 billion. Well, obviously, it's more than a million.
Well, he owned resorts and casinos.
That's true.
And,
that's true. And a beer in Margaritaville and margarita beer and land shark beer.
Who brought me a birthday present?
That one has a message.
Happy birthday,
on.
John Eddie Ray. This is the good. I mean, I'm not doing a product plug here, guys,
but
if you're looking at the video stream, go to jcwshow.com and you can push video. It's a lot better to watch this as a TV show than a radio show. Garrison Brothers. Somebody call them and tell them to send me some free stuff because I'm plugging them. Garrison Brothers special batch or something. Man, this is some good stuff. It's got that special taste of caramel in it.
I can't wait till you pop it open. And I think somebody wrote something.
If anybody wants someone to drink their whiskey, invite Bobo over because he'll do it.
Inside the cover of that book, I think somebody wrote something.
Oh, I've got a book here, too. All the albums. Happy birthday, John. Bobo. Oh, thank you, dude. Led Zeppelin Expanded Edition. That's good. Thank you.
A lot of pictures.
I love Zepp. And out here, it's perfect because I got a ton of my hands. What's in the news, JD? Or Gigi? Or Bobo? Or
Gigi, you want to do news?
Gigi, do you have news?
Well, it was National Beach Day this past week, so we've got some random stand up just for you, just for our friends in here, California. It's comedian Chris Garcia with his memories of living in a beach town. Cut to.
That's not news.
I mean, I'm trying to lighten the mood. I'm trying to help you out, okay?
Grew up in Los Angeles, and one day I got one little fight, and my mom got scared. And she sent me to school in Manhattan Beach, California. Manhattan Beach is a rich Southern California beach town. It's all flip-flops and Adam's apples. My new school had a surf team, a beach volleyball team. The most popular guy in my grade was named Brogan Mollenhoe. Brogan Mollenhoe, dude. What a bro. The first syllable of his name is bro. The last one is ho. Technically, his name is bros before hoes. He ran for class president. His poster said, Brogan, that's my slogan.
What a fool.
And he won. He ran unopposed.
Brogan.
Look at the cans on the Weather Girl on Fox Weather.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh, my Lord. That's affirmative action right there, bud.
I'm sorry. And by cans, what exactly is it that you mean?
Breastises. Breastises.
Oh, okay.
I was concerned about Idalia wins. Idalia.
You're watching the weather because of the girl's cans.
Yeah. And then the girl from Nigeria shows up with a white t-shirt on talking about the hurricane, and her boobs are the size of Bobo's head. Now, that's how you get a job.
That's how you get a job.
Well, alrighty then.
You're not seeing them. You'd be impressed, too. Don't
I am not seeing
right
them. I'm still after my perky breasts, so you're probably right. I would be impressed.
800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO is the call-in number. Craig in Orlando, how was the hurricane?
Doing good. How are you doing, sir?
Good. Did you get hit by the cane? Well, it didn't hit Orlando, but I mean, how did the winds and the rain get?
No, Orlando didn't get anything. We just got a light rain. We got spares, actually.
16 F-150 XL work truck with 125,000 miles. Wants to upgrade 16. Extended cab or crew cab?
Regular cab, long bed, the Coyote 5-liter motor, tow package. The windows rolled down, nothing. Everything's a work package. Air works good. Truck drives good. Pulls good.
That's awesome that, like, you have the most beat down, whop down, least desirable truck in the world, and you throw it's got the Coyote engine in it. Like, anybody gives a rat's ass. The Coyote engine. Well, hang on. I was going to offer you something, but now that you said it's got a Coyote engine and a white long bed regular cab F-150, did anybody get drunk and take baseball bats and beat the hell out of the side of it, too? Just like the rest of the work trucks? Or is it pretty straight?
No, it's actually very straight, very clean. I purchased the truck with 40,000 miles.
He's offended.
It wasn't used, you know.
Is it more than 15 grand?
You're about 15, you said?
No.
I really haven't done no research.
No,
I'm sorry.
I just asked you, is it more than 15 grand? That's a question, not an offer. I just wanted to see if we were...
Be honest.
You don't know. Okay, cool.
Yeah, I didn't do no research. Didn't really...
I didn't either. So you go look and I'll go look and we'll circle back together and bump uglies here in a bit. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO is the call number. The next segment, I'm going to buy cars on the radio like that. Forgive me, the VIN.com. So stay hooked during the music break. And if you want to sell your car to me right now on the radio, call me. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. It's a cheese... Burger in Paradise kind of Saturday morning. Sometimes, no, never. We never take off holiday weekends. We're diehards.
Hardly ever. And that's good.
I stayed up till 2 last night.
Oh my God.
I know it. I'll talk about it. I know it.
It was your turn, dude.
Load the load the calls right now. All over. Everybody, North Carolina, New York City, all of Florida, Georgia County line, all you East Coasters. Oh, hell, we're on the Central too now. Yeah, we got plenty of people. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. My name's John Clay Wolfe. Calling right now. The lightning round is coming up. That's where I bid the cars on the radio. Be right back.
Good God Almighty, which way do I steer for my cheeseburger in paradise? Making the best of every virtue and vice. Worth every damn bit of sacrifice to get a cheeseburger in paradise. Give me the bed.
The John Clay Wolfe Show.
What have you got there?
Divine inspiration.
Want more of the John Clay Wolfe Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Check. Yeah, there you go. That's better. Check 1, 2. I'm just going to have to adjust it. Check. Woo! Check 1, 2, 1, 2. There you go. That's better. Hey. 1, 2, 1, 2. Check.
Thank you.
to the John Clay Wolfe Show, presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Hit him up right now, 1-800-800-RADIO, 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
And this is the lightning round where we buy the cars, bid the cars on the radio for you guys to listen to on behalf of GiveMeTheVin, 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 GiveMeTheVin.com. Roxy, good morning. You're on the air. St. Petersburg, Florida.
Good morning.
17 Nissan diesel.
Correct.
I like that. You know, these things don't resell very well, but I really did like the Cummins engine in that Nissan truck. And, they discontinued it. How long have you had it?
I bought it new in 17.
How many miles a gallon is that Cummins and the Nissan get? Do you know?
Honestly, I don't know. I just put gas in it and go.
Well, if you put gas in it, then I'm in the wrong car. Because I thought it was a diesel.
Yeah, I mean diesel fuel,
correct. Okay, I was all good. Is it leather cloth?
It does not have leather. It has cloth. It's a step up from the basic model.
Okay, SV. I'll give $18,000 for it.
Okay, I'll give it some thought about it.
Go to GiveMeTheVin.com and load it up. Scott in Austin, good morning.
Hey, good morning from Austin, Texas. How's everybody doing?
We are good. Coast to coast, how are you?
Oh, man, it's a beautiful day here in Central Texas. Not a cloud in the sky, not many cars on the road. That means people are taking a break, probably a well-deserved break from busting their balls all week. Happy Labor Day weekend.
How are the liberals in Austin today?
Well, man, they're dancing in the streets.
Alan in Memphis, good morning.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
Good. 16 Laramie Longhorn, Hemi, 80,000 miles, leather roof nav. What color?
It's white.
I don't know, 18, 19, 20? Is that sound right?
Yeah, probably a little lower than I was thinking I'd get for it.
All right. Well, go to GiveMeTheVin.com. The computer will rebid it automatically as soon as you dump the license plate in, and we'll go from there. I'm being lazy. It's Labor Day. I don't want to look it up. I don't want to think that hard. 20 grand is what I'm thinking. Mike in Orlando, you've got a clapped out 300,000-mile truck?
Yes.
Go to GiveMeTheVin.com and load it up. Craig in Midland, 13 terrain, 60,000 miles. Terrain, SLE, 13, 10
John,
years
it's old. A little SUV. It's actually got 64,000 miles. My mother bought it brand new. She's passed on. We're just, I've got everything in line where I can sell it.
Does 13 grand sound right?
Man, that's getting close. I was hoping to get 15.
Load it up into GiveMeTheVin.com. Let's work on it. My name's John Clay. Thanks, Craig.
All right.
My name's John Clay Wolfe of Buy Cars and Radio for America's Best Car Buyer. GiveMeTheVin.com. So easy you can do it in your jock strap.
You're listening to the most popular Saturday morning show to ever broadcast in America. You're listening to the John Clay Wolfe Show. Feel free to call and make your voice heard. 800-800-RADIO. If you missed any of the show, go to jcwshow.com right now and download the podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show. John Clay Wolfe Show, America's largest weekend morning show.
Presented by GimmeTheGun.com.
Call in 800-800-RADIO and check out the podcast at JCWShow.com or JohnClayWolfe.com.
Is the hurricane called Idalia?
Idalia,
like
correct.
The song? Like the Vidalia onions?
Very similar.
Like the onions, the onions.
Idalia. Vidalia. Good morning, everybody. Jimmy Buffett's passed away. For those of y'all who just turned on the, woke up and turned on the deal. He is not going to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show.
Indeed.
Florida news.
Florida news.
Florida news. Florida in three, news. Two, one. Hey, Turley, use your mouse.
Florida news. Well, speaking of the hurricane, Hurricane Idalia created quite a bit of havoc all up and down the coast of Florida, by the way, in the midst.
And now, from North America's own land down under.
He's so hard-headed he won't use his mouse. He'd rather wreck the segment out than use his mouse.
You don't tell him what to do.
Nope.
J.P. Ryan.
In the midst of all the flooding, by the way, you know, they send the news guys out to cover the flooding and everything. Well, they send the local Bay News 9 meteorologist, Van Dam, in Tampa Bay, filming the storm surge. And as he was filming, two guys floated by in a giant inflatable duck in the middle of all of it. Cut number 7.
This is something you don't see every day. Guys, what are you doing? Literally,
this is a
very new way to beat rush hour traffic on Bayshore Boulevard in Tampa. These guys are kayaking down this major thoroughfare. I mean, look at that. I don't want to minimize the serious nature of this storm, but this is what people are dealing with in Tampa as we speak.
Did you ever think that you would be kayaking down Bayshore Boulevard?
I was always hoping, but I never knew for sure.
Well, now your dreams have come true.
Anyway, there were a lot of flooding, but for the most part, it came and went. It wasn't a terrible storm. It hit us a low 3. Anyway, another 30-year-old guy in Florida arrested on Tuesday. This is a terrible thing to do. Your ex-girlfriend texted him a picture of another guy's junk and said how small he was compared to this guy. And of course, they obviously didn't show. No, it's not.
It's an observation.
It's not. Anyway.
Honey, thank God you're hung better than this guy.
They got three kids together, so clearly the junk does work. Either way, Rashad McGriff got arrested in Vero Beach, Florida on Tuesday.
Wait. Why'd he got arrested for having a Big Johnson?
No, he attacked her after all.
The other guys was bigger.
Yeah, the other guys was bigger.
She showed him a picture to prove it.
Well, like, is it her boyfriend?
Husband.
Okay, she showed her husband, her boyfriend?
Some other guy's business.
But like, had she been mounting up on that other guy's business?
We don't know that.
But or was it just an observation?
Rashad McGriff apparently thought she was.
Oh.
So he went and did a not a good thing. He is facing battery and burglary charges. This is cut number 8.
He talks like he's some kind of rich guy, but he acts like a little whiny bitch guy. I don't want to smash that he's like this guy. Kind of sounds like a tiny little guy.
That's perfect.
Does he have a picture of his so we can be the final judge and jury?
We can compare and contrast.
Do not download pornography on company equipment. So.
Yeah.
All I can think about is Tommy Lee Schlong.
It is big.
I mean, but let me ask you guys. Why? What are you thinking when you send a picture of your Falun Weiwei to someone? Why?
You want this. Right. Come and get it.
You know, I mean, and even if you did, that's like sending a picture of food to someone who's starving. What are they going to do with that?
They're going to be ready
Nothing.
When you get there.
No.
So when they do it to you, Gigi, how do you take it?
You know what I do?
No, tell me.
I do a screenshot, and then I draw like a two eyes and a mouth and a little hat and arms and send it back. Yeah, what am I supposed to do with that?
So when I was in sixth grade, my dad had a boat, 44 Trojan cabin cruiser. And he was going through a weird moment in his life where he was getting divorced and he had this boat loaded with hoes.
Boats and hoes.
Boats and hoes.
Hand in hand.
And down below the cabin, there was a bunch of stuff. People have their stuff, right? And they're all up there. And there was a camera there. And I, for some reason, thought it'd be funny to grab... This is back in the day of film cameras. You must get them...
Stop laughing.
You must get them developed.
Sure.
And speaking of developed, that's where this story goes awry. So I snapped a picture of my junk.
Oh my God.
On a random camera that was sitting on a countertop.
Oh no.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
That's pretty amazing.
A lot of people have done that now.
What?
You were the first to do that then.
That's right.
I mean, like where they had to go to Fox Photo and get the. So then my dad, about a month later, comes and talks to me about it. And said, what were you thinking? I was like, it wasn't me.
How do you know it was me?
How do you know it was me? Well, because you don't have, you're underdeveloped.
Ooh.
And you could catch the boat. And in the film processes, you got before the boat and after the boat. So it was obviously during the boat trip.
Got it.
And I'm down below in the cabin and snapped a picture. I took a selfie for the old gal, but I didn't have any hair on it.
A little worm.
Wow. I don't know. Why did that story just come up?
Wow, because we're talking about underdeveloped. Yeah, that you were. Your father said you were underdeveloped.
That's why you're so fascinated with Tommy Lee Schlong.
Yeah,
probably.
Yeah. I was. Mine was photoed at an early age by myself, albeit. But it's not fun to be busted out on something like that.
No.
You know, when you think you're getting away with something and you're not.
Speaking of Tommy Lee Schlong, apparently he's got a birthday wish for you too. His actual Schlong does.
Oh, good.
John, hi.
Are you Tommy Lee Schlong?
Yeah, I thought I'd just... I mean, I really appreciate the attention you've given me the last few weeks or so. I feel like we've become so close. You know what I mean?
So Tommy Lee Schlong is on the phone with me right now.
Yeah, I just thought I'd send a happy cock-a-doodle-doo. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, you don't remember us having Tommy Lee
I Schlong forgot when Tommy Lee Schlong called in to talk and wished me happy birthday. Was that last year or a couple years ago?
That was last year.
Yeah.
You're going to hear it every year.
Tommy Lee Schlong calls to greet me happy birthday. Well, this is the glorious ending to a birthday week. When you're, I think any dad, husband over 40, dad and husband, you don't have to be, anyway, gets a birthday week, not a birthday day, because you have responsibilities. You can't really take off and go to the amusement park all day. So you just take little nuggets of it throughout the week. And that's what I've been doing. And
economize.
Today's the wrap up. Speaking of, I didn't realize there was college football in the past 2 nights.
Oh, yeah. It's a big weekend. It's opening weekend, basically.
Yeah, but I didn't know that they... I thought the football was today, not Thursday night. There was a good game Thursday night, wasn't there? Did you watch it?
I did not watch it. Was it Utah played, and they beat Florida?
Right.
I don't remember the
final. Sorry, Florida.
Yeah.
Minnesota, Nebraska.
Right. Yeah.
Which was a really close game. Minnesota pulled it out 13-10. Nebraska's up and coming. So.
Yeah, nice defensive matchup, that one. I was amazed to turn on the TV Thursday night and there's a college game.
But the big games are this today. I say big games. There's only one real big game.
Which one's that?
And that's going to be the Florida State Seminoles versus LSU tonight.
That is a big
6:30
game.
Yeah.
Central time. Yeah, number 5 LSU, number 8 Florida State.
Did you see what the spread is on the TCU-Colorado game?
21.
I was not expecting that at all. I thought that this was a close contest. The bookies do not believe in Dion. I think he is hyped.
I would take the under, John. You want to make a bet? I think Colorado's going to hold him.
Here we go.
I think he's baiting me. Why would you ask me if I want to take the bet against you?
I'm just asking. Mm-hmm. You know, it's that time, John. Remember last year we started betting?
I will take the under. $1, $5, $20, $10. What do you want to do?
So you think Colorado's going to
beat the points? Beat the points. Beat. All right. I mean,
I want to do that.
Okay. I thought you. No.
Damn it.
Okay, I'll do it. I'll be easy. So I'm taking TCU with the points, right?
Yep.
Okay. No, I'm taking Colorado with the points.
Yes. So you're saying TCU will cover the spread?
They won't, but that's fine. I'll bet it $5. Okay. Now I'll set the bet.
$10.
$10.
All right.
Okay, what's the next one?
Well, that's just the one right there. There's a lot more games we can go over.
If I'm going to make this stupid bet, this chump bet, this pee down my leg bet, then I want the rest of them too.
Okay, so
there's safety in the numbers. Yeah.
All right, $25 a game.
We'll get to the rest of them as soon as we come back. Okay. My name is John Clay Wolfe of Buy Cars on Radio for America's Best Car Buyer. Give me the fin.com.
Heard on the air every Saturday morning. From New York to Los Angeles to Houston and broadcasting to the rest of the world online at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. You're listening to The John Clay Wolfe Show. Want more of The John Clay Wolfe Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com.
Check, 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 check. Hey, 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 1-2, 1-2.
coast, the number one weekend morning show in America. Heard in Miami, Washington, D.C., Pittsburgh, Charlotte, Orlando, Cincinnati, and broadcasting to the rest of the world at johnclaywolfe.com or jcwshow.com. Call John toll free 1-800-800-RADIO. 800-800-RADIO. The John Clay Wolfe Show. Thanks for making us America's number one Saturday morning show.
It is Labor Day.
Good to say that.
And Jimmy Buffett is not going to San Francisco. He passed away last night at 76.
Please don't say mañana.
If you don't mean it.
Dwayne, Tallahassee.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What you got? What you got? What you got?
I'm just going to let you know LSU and Florida State is Sunday night.
Ah, totally wrong.
Fact check, fact check. Fact
checkers.
Thank you, yeah.
We need fact checkers because we are full of it all the time.
And he's correct. It is Sunday. Sorry. Right.
That, what's that the line, Dwayne? Do you know?
Not sure. Not sure. Going to be a good game.
Right. What's the line, Charlie?
The line is 2 points. LSU is favored.
Okay. So we're doing four bets, $25 a beat, and the first one was TCU Colorado, and the line on that's minus 22?
20 and a half.
20.5 Colorado. And I took Colorado.
No, you took TCU. No,
I took TCU.
You keep trying to take Colorado.
Okay. Okay, and then the next one is Florida State and LSU.
Yeah, at Florida State.
At Florida State, minus two.
Yep, LSU's favored.
I take LSU.
Ah,
yeah, I took the dumb one last time. You get the dumb one this time.
This is not about getting the dumb one. All right, all right. I'll go with that
Penn
one.
Penn State, fine. West Virginia.
Yes, Penn State, West Virginia. Penn State is favored by 20 and a half. It's hard to find games that are under 30-point spreads right now for week one, so...
So, who do you want?
I'll take Penn State on that one, yeah. Okay. I'll win by 20 and a half.
Early. And then, what's the next one?
We'll go with the... I mean, like I said, it's hard to find anything under 30 points. Here we go. Boise State versus Washington. Washington number 10. Washington's only favored by 14.
I'll take Boise.
All right. All right, I like that. I'll take Washington on that.
Okay. Why do you say Boise State and Washington so pricky?
Like, what the hell is that?
Pricky is like they don't count. They're not real people. Just because they're bleeding heart liberals up on the... Well, Boise really isn't. I mean, don't... They're people, too. You don't have to look down your nose at them.
I wasn't meaning to.
Well, I heard it. Did you hear it, JD?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Just,
it's a real bitchy backslap about Boise State
and
Washington.
They're not real people. This is not a real school.
Now, is Washington the one that has no conference? It's a horse with no name?
Yeah, they're part of that pack. That's no longer the Pac-12.
They're the lone pack? Lone wolf, the one-man wolf pack.
Did you hear where SMU's going?
SMU is going to the Atlantic Athletic Conference.
Yeah.
Thank God. Right where we need to be with snobby, educated, overinflated, good sports teams like Notre Dame, Clemson, and whom else? There's another bitchy.
Well, Cal will be joining him. Cal, Stanford now.
Stanford. See, that raises the elevation of my education.
Oh, is that what it is?
Because now we're in a conference with Dame and Stanford. Yeah.
It's a perfect place for him.
It really is. Did you know what the line is on a Hawaii home game? So, Bobbo, or Gigi, I'll ask the dumb blonde questions.
Okay.
Wow.
How many points does a team get in college football for a home game on the spreads, on the lines, the betting?
5 or 7.
3.
Oh.
Close.
Okay.
All right. How many points does a team get when they travel to Hawaii?
5 or 7.
7.
Oh, wow. I was right.
All right.
I didn't even know.
I know.
A touchdown.
So when in the reason, time zone changes, long travel.
Oh.
How many points are they going to give Stanford when they go to Clemson or Florida? I mean, it is a flight to Hawaii.
It's a haul.
Four time zones.
Yep.
That's crazy. Think about women's basketball. Well, you were a lesbianic women's basketball okay. player, right?
I was the one they wanted.
Right. At Grambling State?
Talladega.
Talladega Nights with Gigi.
That's right. You ain't first, you last.
So the women's basketball team in California... is going to have to travel to Tennessee to play. I mean, this is just going to be a mess.
That, Clemson, yeah.
That's... The distances. Oh, yeah, Clemson. What, there are no Tennessee teams.
No, but
yeah,
Clemson, sorry. That's a draw.
Anyway, they have to travel to the East Coast with Florida. And can you imagine the travel bill? Can you imagine those poor kids? I mean, when you're going, like, let's say you're through the women's volleyball schedule and you're down to the last third and you've been getting blown out and hadn't won a game. You're in California. You've got to go to Florida to play another one. Can you just phone it in and say, hey, man, we're not coming?
Never mind.
Well, think about this. Syracuse is in that conference, too. Stanford to Syracuse.
It's unbelievable.
That's a haul. I mean, you know what? It's going to be what? Maybe four big conferences, five, and that's it.
Scott has a nude story in Arlington, Texas. Good morning, Scott.
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good.
Number one, you are one of the funniest people on radio. The problem with it's a God-given talent. The reason that people don't get your comedy is because they were mad. They've been mad their entire lives. They're still mad. They're not going to get out of their madness because they cannot see comedy when it presents itself.
Thank you, Scott. Now, you thought you saw some comedy with nude photos. Is that right?
Unfortunately, my wife had a bad habit when they had the digital cameras at every wedding. She had to take a bunch of stupid pictures, and I'm tired of looking at them. And every time, I said, I'm going to end this right now. So one morning when she was asleep, I took a picture of myself, as you did.
Right.
And to me, my daughter said, well, I'm going to go scroll through these pictures and see how the wedding went last night. But, you know, look, it's our whole family is comedy. So she got it. She goes, I cannot believe what Dad did this morning. She knew. And then if that wasn't bad enough, my wife takes that camera to Walgreens, downloads them, and then that picture gets printed.
Is it framed in the kitchen?
No, it's in a special box in the closet. Let's just put it that way.
Thank you, Scott. Okay, now that he's not with us, is anybody else a little creeped out?
That's the difference
all kinds
between
of creepy and
Dallas and Arlington.
Isn't that the truth? Isn't that the truth?
Every city has something like that. The Arlington to Dallas types.
Oh yeah. I mean, that's where all the hoes were, dude.
Yeah.
When you were in high school and you were hunting, it was in college, the Arlington gals. I know we're around the country. You know, Dallas Cowboys play in Arlington, Texas. Arlington, Texas is between Fort Worth and Dallas. So it's eternal hoe ground. Like, Hooters started, I'm sure, in Arlington, Texas. That's where it was designed.
I think you're
was
right.
Was it really?
I think you're right.
I just made that up.
I believe you're correct.
Okay. So the country girl leaves small town, moves to the big city. Where could she go? Place that has affordable housing, lots of clubs to go out in and meet a guy.
Clubs.
That's Arlington, Texas. So like 80% of the population was hot, wild country poontang.
And they had all the topless clubs up and down. There's a highway that goes through Arlington called 360, mm-hmm. and that's where all the strip clubs
were. If you want to lose your virginity, you need to go to Arlington, Texas.
And all the ball teams play there.
I mean, you're Mr. Arlington, Texas. Am I missing anything?
Oh, no. I used to work at a radio station. Our studios was right there in Arlington, Texas.
Oh, boy.
Right across from
me. How many times have you been laid in Arlington, Texas, J.D., or with a Arlington, Texas effect?
Well, because I worked for a country radio station, and we did a remote every Friday night in Arlington, Texas at a country thing called Cowboys.
Oh, yeah.
Every Friday. That's why Joe...
I'm not looking for a story. I'm looking for a number.
That's where I met Joe Exotic, was Cowboys. Oh. And he used to come in with the Tigers.
If you screwed Joe Exotic,
no,
I
did not screw Joe Exotic. So the answer is a number I'd rather not disclose. So,
were the women easier in Arlington, Texas?
Well, because, yeah, it was that Friday night. It was you're a bar. You're a radio guy. I mean, come on. Yes.
800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO is our call-in number. Ty in Oklahoma, your Gladiator Rubicon, I think it's worth $37,000.
Oh, okay.
They're all tough, right. Dude. Those things kind of suck. Yeah, I kind of. We keep losing money on them. They're oversold. They're a little overpriced. It's a truck. If you want a truck, go get a truck. Don't be a poser and drive a Jeep truck. Just get a truck. Take your.
I am between old. Hey, I was going to ask y'all something. Y'all was talking about Arlington. Y'all remember Speed's Billiards?
Yeah.
Sure. Right. That's all I needed to know. My name's John Clay Wolfe. I got to go.
The John Clay Wolfe Show is heard every week on great stations. Catch the nation's fastest growing podcast and live video stream at johnclaywolfe.com. We'll be right back.
seconds, 30 seconds.
To the John Clay Wolfe Show.
I ain't as good as I once was. I got a few years on me now. But there was a time back in my prime when I could really lay
Who
it
in
down.
The hell approved hey, this babe. Song?
I know turning 50 has been a little hard on you, but after being with you for almost 2 decades, I'm pretty convinced that you age at half the speed of everyone else. So it's basically like you're turning 25. That also means that your brain is now fully developed, so you have no more excuses for making bad decisions. Happy birthday. I'm so proud of you, and I'm so thankful I get to be married to you. I love you so, so much, and hope you have an amazing time celebrating this weekend. You deserve it.
Hey, Dad. Happy birthday. I love you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday, Dad. Love your favorite daughter ever, Tabitha. Mwah.
Hi, Dad. Happy birthday. Can't wait to see you soon. I'm having a fun time here, and I hope you have a great birthday. Bye. Love you.
Happy birthday, John, from your in-laws in Denmark. We love you and hope you have a great day.
To the family.
Broadcasting live from the Wolfe Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolfe Show, America's largest weekend morning show. Call in 800-800-RADIO and check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com.
Well, now everybody knows what my wife sounds like. She doesn't. We blew the cover.
Ever.
She doesn't sound like Melania Trump.
Not at Never all. On the show.
Did people say that?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you say your wife's from Europe or Denmark. They think that she talks like it is. Like my, did you hear my in-laws?
Hoppy, choppy, sloppy, jobba.
I love it when they put things on Facebook. It always looks like someone sat on a keyboard.
800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO. Well, that was nice.
That was very nice. Happy birthday. Hope you've had a great week.
Thank you. I have.
Good, good, good.
I need to, I want to hit this real quick. John in Maryland, you have a 51 MG midget?
MGTT.
Oh, a TD. That's like, does that kind of look like a Morgan? Like what Michael Douglas drove in War of the Roses?
Yeah, ostensibly, yes.
Right. I don't know what it's worth. What... Okay, so it's that little roadster thing. It's not the dumb midget. I hate MG midgets. Do you hate them with me?
Yes.
John from
actually,
Maryland?
Actually, the midget was actually a kind of cute little car, predecessor to the Miata.
I always lose money on midgets. And I bet on them a lot. But the damn MG midget is... it's tough. Yeah, I can't make a profit on one. I bought one with 60,000 miles on it for $5,000 yesterday, and I was just cussing that damn midget the whole way and cussing my buyer that bought it. I said, I hate midgets. I hate these things. I don't want them, but, I mean, we've got a number of the cars for the public, the tall ones and the short ones. And anyway, your TD, 1951 MGTD.
Yes,
how much does it need work, or is it restored?
It is not restored. It is a survivor car. The motor work has been done. The motor needs to be put back in the car.
Ooh. Well, you need to get off your ass and do that, because I'm not doing it for you. I mean, don't call me with your housekeeping, bud. I mean, you want me to do your laundry, too, while I come over?
It's not my housekeeping.
Whose is it, then?
The car came here... because the owner was going to come here on weekends and put it together at my shop. And then that turned into 13 years of never seeing him.
Okay, so I'll come. Do you have a title?
Yes, I do.
So do you want to just give it to me? And I'll send a record over and pick it up?
No, actually I don't.
It's guy's kind of a prick. Kind of a prick. I hear a prick. Anybody else hear a prick?
Would it be more valuable if it had a Coyote motor in it?
It would. So, what would you take for it?
$8,000.
You got it for free. Don't be a. Okay.
I got it. I'm not. I'm not going to. 13 years worth of storage.
I'm not going to build your friend's car and take on that project. Find another sucker. I'm not the sucker. I'll give $500.
It's worth more than that in scrap, and you know it.
You're damn right. But somebody's got to get off their ass and go do all this. And if I'm going to do this job, then I'm going to get paid. Does it look like free to you? Where am I doing this for Jerry's kids? Is this the Jerry Lewis telethon? No, I'm not. Doing this for money, and I'm not getting beat out of money by a damn midget lover again. 800-800-7234.
That's a good drop.
Go ahead.
I'm not getting beat out of money over a midget lover.
Somebody had to say it.
Yeah.
Somebody had to say it.
Short people got no reason to live.
No, it's a car we're talking about. 800-800-7234. 800-800 radio.
John's feisty today.
I know, he's feisty.
I bought an old clapped out Trans Am that's showing up tomorrow. For nothing like that, and we're going to rebuild it. It's a 79.
Oh. It was literally paying the guy to remove it from his barn. Yeah. I mean, that's...
Wow.
Hey...
We will definitely have more in shipping than what we paid for the car.
Yeah.
But it'll be a good one for our first episode of this YouTube channel TV thing that we're working on to actually take a car and restore it. But, I mean, who would... I mean, how many views do you think you would get with a Trans Am redo versus a midget? I mean, if she was a good-looking midget, that's one thing. But, oh, this isn't a midget. This is a T-O, car. An T-D. O-T, yeah. A T-D, yeah. An O-T.
Okay.
Yeah. It's
same thing, basically.
No. What do you call STD? That's what it is.
Oh.
Lord.
Yeah. Did you know you can get cancer from kissing a woman in that special place?
Okay. Oh, my God. I am so glad you said that.
I have a doctor friend out here hunting with me this weekend, and we got a little drunk last night. That's why I'm draggy. And there's a group of us, and he's a cancer doctor. And he said, absolutely.
Hold on. This is breaking news, everyone.
Yeah.
I'm surprised that my head hasn't fallen off.
Don't do it, laddie. Get out while you can.
So we're all, well, I say we're all.
Everybody's leaning into the radio like it's 1952 and they're listening to the show.
Oh my God.
We're going to get cancer?
They're hunting right now. Those guys got up early. And I told them to come up later in the show so we can, I want to hear this from the doctor's mouth.
Okay.
Yeah, it's in medical news today. I just looked it up. I just thought John made it up, but no, it's true. Oral sex and oral and throat cancer. There is, because of the oral HPV that can be transferred. It's not actual cancer, but it gives you the HPV, which can turn into cancer.
Well, Michael Douglas said that.
I was going to say. I thought I was the only one who noticed.
No.
Right. He said it cured his throat cancer.
Oh, I thought it was the other way around.
If you kiss, what's her name? His ex-wife or his wife?
Catherine Zeta-Jones.
Yeah, then she's got the antithesis of cancer. She has the special serum.
Yeah.
So,
y'all is too nasty.
Codename Sunshine.
Read it like it's a news story so we can get out of this bit and get clean.
Me.
JD.
Oral cancer is just one type of head and neck cancer. Data from the CDC indicates that about 7% of the people who have had oral relations possibly have oral HPV, which can turn into cancer.
Well, I'll be damned.
Yeah, you want happy news. There you go.
Told you I was going to die young. 800-800-7234, 800-800.
It's the death show. We opened with Jimmy Buffett dying, and now this.
Radio. Rob in Memphis, you have a midget?
Yeah, so I had a midget. A guy owed me some money, gave me this
midget
Dodge Dynasty, like a 1984 Dodge Dynasty, one of them ugly white.
He didn't know
cars.
You much.
And yeah, and so he traded me that, and then I had somebody offer, it's like either a 68 or 73, somewhere in there, midget. It's green with the drop top, wasn't completely restored. You know, I'm like a.
I'd kick that thing down the street. I hate midgets. And the cars. Mike, you have a 75 Porsche 911. I'm going to bid that one. I actually sent your information to one of my buyers who are going to contact you. I have a Porsche specialist.
Are you okay. there?
I have a guy on my team that's Porsche specialist, and those old Porsches like that are all different. So I'm having a guy contact you directly. So if you're getting a call from Nashville, Tennessee, that's my guy.
Okay.
Thanks. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. Edward in Palm Bay, Florida.
Hi, John.
Hey, what are you saying? The TV, who can't be on TV on football?
Okay. I am saying because of Spectrum News. I mean, that's Spectrum News. Spectrum Cable Company. They're a cable internet company. They're huge. Have you heard of them?
Yes.
They're cool. Okay. They blacked out because of payment or whatever. They've blacked out ESPN on our lineup on the TV.
Wow.
And FX movie channel, because Spectrum don't want to pony up the money that they're supposed to be paying Disney, because Disney owns ESPN. And there's a big feud going on, and people like us are suffering because we can't even watch TV, ESPN, on Saturday game day, because the channels are blacked out.
Do you think you can get mouth cancer from Pinocchi?
Yes.
All right. Thank you, Edward. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. My name is John Clay Wolfe. The next segment is the car segment, the lightning round. Call in right now during this song and load us up. I'll bid your car to buy your car on the air right now for America's Best Car Buyer. Give me the VIN, like VIN number, give me the VIN.com. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO is the call-in number, and this is the hot Wilson sister from Heart.
It's Gigi from the John Clay Wolfe Show. Do you want the most money for your used car? Do you want a hassle-free process? Of course you do. Give Me the VIN will beat your written CarMax offer or write you a check for $100. It's that simple. Give Me the VIN is A-plus rated by the BBB and thousands of online reviews. Get an instant cash offer and the most money for your used car right now at GiveMeTheVIN.com. America's best car buyer.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com. So easy you can do it in your
Yeah, some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
Love above.
Stand by.
To the John Clay Wolfe Show, presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Hit him up right now, 1-800-800-RADIO. 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
And this is the lightning round where we bid cars on the radio for you and yours to enjoy. Scott in Houston.
Yep.
The bids are good at GiveMeTheVin.com. So you have a 78 C-body, square-body Chevy with 70,000. But the Odo doesn't work, so just it doesn't matter how many miles. Figure it's got set, whatever. But it's the long, it's a two-wheel drive long bed?
Yeah, 8 foot bed. So I don't know how far she's been or how fast she's going, but
I think she's.
I also don't know how much she got in the tank.
I think she's 2,500.
Okay.
I'm guessing, but I need to see pictures. I mean, is this some whopped out, like weeds growing out of it kind of rig?
No. It starts right up. It gets a lot of attention everywhere I go. Okay. I'm trying to get like a baseline.
Makes sense. Go to GiveMeTheVin.com and let's see. Sounds good. Jim, you have a 21 Tacoma with 16,000 miles on it. How it says it's lifted. How much lift is on it?
It's got the factory 2-inch lift.
What will you take for it?
I'll take 40.
A 21, and we're in 23, Toyota Tacoma TRD. Is it a TRD Pro?
Yep. No, it's not the Pro.
All right. Jim, are you in an arguing kind of mood this morning? Because I damn sure are. Is. I am. Am. So I'm going to bust your balls.
I've been hearing you on the radio.
I want to bust your balls, Jim. Let's bust Jim's balls, everybody. He's got a 16,000-mile, three-year-old truck that he wants damn near sticker for. You know, and I know this for sure because I bought my son a green one, and the sticker on it was 44.7.
That's what this one is.
Right.
This is green.
Yeah, why the hell, in what world and what planet do you think your truck that's 3 years old is worth a sticker?
It's because it's clean. It's clean, I mean, front to back, inside and out.
Dude, there's a lot.
It's got the clear bra, all the scratch resistance all the way around it. It's got Pro Comp tire rims on it, good tires on it, brand new, full-size spare.
That's great.
With the Pro Comp.
Good. That's fine, but your stuff's not worth sticker, dog. I mean, you people need to get off this. Y'all need to straighten up and realize COVID has come and COVID has left. Less this truck stickers for about $43,000 is probably worth $35,000, which is a ton. It's worth a ton.
Not according to the government. Not according to government. They say it's coming back.
Marie Laveau. Well, so you don't want to sell your car. You just want to call and argue.
No, not really.
What's your payoff?
What are you thinking?
It doesn't matter what I'm thinking.
31. 31.
Yeah, I'll
31
pay,
and change.
I'll pay it off for you and let you buy me a steak dinner. How's that? 800-800-723. I think 35. Monte Carlo. Steve, Monte Carlo's. Send me some. Oh, it's a lowrider. Are you a Mexican?
No. No, I'm a white boy.
Is that why you're selling it?
No, I'm 61 years old now, so I'm not, you know, I grew up in California, and the white boys were doing the lowrider scene.
Okay.
And
now you're in Florida, you know, and they're not.
No.
Do you have a Puerto Rican girlfriend?
No, I had a Mexican here. Wife, he's though.
There you go. There you go. I wasn't far off, Gigi. I asked, I mean, just right out of this, I said, are you a Mexican? And he said, no, I'm California. Yeah, he drug his ass all the way over to the East Coast, just like Stanford's going to do, to play a volleyball game, now that they joined that new league. Anyway, his wife is Mexican, so he brings his lowrider. Did you bait her with the lowrider?
Of course. Of course. Custom cars, how you going to get, you know?
Right. It's like a fish hook.
No.
You caught a Mexican.
It's really...
You caught a Mexican on the end of a 73 Monte Carlo slammed down. Well, good for you. All right. I got loaded into GiveMeTheVin.com. GiveMeTheVin.com. When they play this back, when they use this clip,
yeah,
they're like, they're going to want to... People are going to want to be offended that that's racist, but you can't.
You were spitting facts, that's
How
all.
Can you... I mean, GG, fact check me. Racist check me.
You know what? It sounded racist at the beginning, but you were not racist. You were right.
Brian, these trucks are the stupidest trucks that God's ever created. Did you know that? A 22 Ford Maverick?
Nah, man, this Jimmy Buffett bought a comp cruiser today. This would be it.
If, yeah, I'm trying to think of a good one. Who would drive a Ford Maverick? I mean, when I first saw it, I thought it was a Hyundai. I mean, it's like the EV equivalent of an EV truck. It's what's weird is they kind of sell and people like them.
It's an FX4, though. It's sure blue.
It's got 20,000 miles on it.
I know, man, but I got a new one ordered coming in. I need to sell this one so I can buy the other one.
I think it's 27,000.
That's below MSRP.
Kiss my ass. My name's John Clay Wolfe. I buy cars on the radio for America's best car buyer. Give me the VIN.com.
Broadcasting on air, online, anywhere you are, with a smartphone and an internet connection. Check out the podcast, jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com.
Yo, we're back to the John Clay Wolfe Show, taking over your radio every Saturday morning, broadcasting all across America. Los Angeles, Houston, Dallas, Nashville, San Diego, Las Vegas, Denver, New Orleans, Oklahoma City, Austin. Hit them up, 800-800-RADIO, the John Clay Wolfe Show. If you missed any of the show, go to jcwshow.com right now and download the podcast. Give me the vent! Now, John Clay Wolfe.
So get this, Thursday night. Middle school football.
Yes.
Travel game. Mm-hmm. Our way in Dallas, Addison. My kid is playing his first game of the year, eighth grade. He's the second string quarterback. He's good, but there's a kid that, above him that they recruited that's better. But he has this guy on his, this coach on his team that played at that school. He played at TCU, and he's been the quarterback coach at this school called All Saints in Fort Worth.
All right.
And my son's just really getting into him. He's really getting into my son. He's been like that person, that big brother. I mean, he's coaching him tons. And, I mean, all the way home after the big win the other night, my son is talking about what that guy was telling him and all these tips. And he's just really excited about his relationship with his coach. But he's a young coach. He's in college. He's a junior at TCU.
Oh, wow.
So he takes off from college and goes over and does middle school practice. He got shot 2 hours after that, and he's dead.
Shut.
Oh, my what? God. What?
Yeah, Wes Smith is the name.
How? What?
I drive by is what I heard. Turley, do you know?
Yeah.
Turley's kid goes to school there, too, and Turley's involved with the football program.
Yeah, so Wes Smith was off. There's an area in Fort Worth, Texas called 7th Street. He was just leaving a bar, and a guy randomly walked up to him. They started talking, and then this guy shot him 3 times. It was a random act of shooting, too. No reason.
No rhyme, fight, no argument.
No girl involved. I heard that he was putting a girl in an Uber.
Doesn't read that. It goes on here to say that this gentleman was going to shoot other people, too. So it was one of these guys that just wanted to shoot somebody. I mean, it's so stupid. It's just dumb. But this guy, Coach Wes Smith, was known for. All Saints kid. This kid was taking time from
college
to teach middle school kids and just senselessly killed. Very sad. Very sad.
I thought we left Chicago.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do in that case. I mean, there's no, I got a gun on me. You don't have time to pull it if somebody just walks up to you and shoots you.
3 times shot him.
3 times? I did not know that.
Yeah, 3 times.
That's sad. That is your son okay?
No. I mean,
yeah.
I'm sure he's not. It's going to be bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, I told my wife, I'm like, you need to get in the car and go on over there. Because when they told the kids in a forum, I was like, he's going to come. He's going to go apart. He's going to come to pieces more than any of them. Because he was super, duper, duper close to him. God's weird. All right. Anyway, rest in peace, Wes. Thank you for helping my son. You were good. All right, Bob, Denver, Downer. You there? Sideshow Bob, Denver, Colorado. You've got a 23 Corvette LT2. What is MSRP?
98.
And you want MSRP for it?
I mean, hey, listen, yeah. If you can give me a dollar more, I'd love it.
I hear you. Go to it depends. It's not a Z. It's not a Z51 package, is it? Or is it?
It is.
Oh, that's good. Probably. Go to Give Me the Vent. This is one of the few cars that are still sticker. Go to GiveMeTheVent.com and load it up. Let me it's right there. The bring money is right there at sticker. Like what I can get for it is just right there at sticker. So I need to figure, I've got to pick it up from you. I've got to pay a guy to handle the deal. I have to pay transportation. I've got to pay an auction fee. So I'm going to have to back you up just a little bit, but not much. I don't need to make much. I mean, if I can clear $300 a car, I'm good. Makes sense? All right. But I mean, I don't know. Anyway, please load the car into GiveMeTheVin.com, and the best thing you can do to get it fast is take a picture of the window sticker when you submit your photos, and that'll speed it up a lot.
Mm-hmm. Sweet.
Thanks, man. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. It is time for Mail from Jail.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
JD, you want to color up mail for Jill? I'm tired of y'all are working me too much. I don't have to talk all the time. I pay everybody here, and I'm the one doing all the goddamn plugs and all the bits, and I'm having to do all the work. I'm getting tired of it.
It's your show.
Yeah, but I mean, can y'all not do something?
We sure can. Every week we get all kinds of mail from people that are in jail, actually, the prisons. They love us. They write
Hang
to
on,
us
lady,
week.
Lady, lady, that I just said the GD. I apologize. I've been getting emails from...
Parents are in their car.
I shouldn't have said that. I'm sorry. I lost my cool. I'm mad at JD for being lazy. and I blurted out, and I took the Lord's name in vain, and I apologize. Go ahead.
All right. Not like the time you talked about Santa Claus. All right, let's move forward. we get letters every week from people in jail. They got a lot of time, and they love listening to the show. So we bring in Johnny Cash from heaven to read them letters, and that's what he's doing. Hey, Johnny.
You know, J.D. Ryan.
You're looking good.
My condolences to John Clay Wolfe.
Why?
It hurts my heart to see a grown man cry.
I know. He's having a hard time with this particular birthday. Hey, I want to talk to you because you're in heaven. I want to talk to you to see if Jimmy Buffett's up there. Maybe later, after your letter.
Well, I haven't seen anything. I've been, been off the clock until about 20 minutes ago.
Gotcha.
But we do keep an eye out.
All right.
I heard he was a good old boy.
Yeah.
Yes, never spend much time around him. This week's letter reads, Hello, John. They say hell is hot, but jail is hotter. My name is Lawrence, and I'm getting my ass kicked in jail by this Texas heat. At least y'all cool kids get to entertain me on Saturdays, but I could sure use some help. We could buy little fans to keep cool when the AC isn't working, which is a lot of the time down here, and I am plumb out of money. I try to straighten up every time I get caught, but I spend quite a bit of my life in the correctional facilities of this country. Something just keeps calling me back to crime. I'm from Oklahoma, but I spent the last few years in Texas. Hot damn, do y'all need to fix the AC down here. I'm in one of those units with a lot of bunk beds in one room, and we're being cooked alive every day. It's hitting 100 degrees inside here, and the guards, of course, don't seem to care. The only relief we find is cold showers, and those are in high damn demand.
Maybe you shouldn't have gone to prison, dumbass.
which makes me wonder, would you be able to send a loyal listener a few bucks? I feel like one of those cooked chickens you find in Walmart under them heat lamps. Damn, I'd kill for one of those things. In advance, thanks a lot.
What a
Larry
wild.
McCauley, Huntsville, Texas.
Larry McCauley.
But like I said,
down
John.
They need to, hey, guys, when y'all write us mail from Joe, please tell us what you're doing time for.
It hurts to see a grown man cry.
I'm going to guess meth because it's Oklahoma.
That's a pretty good educated guess.
Thanks, Johnny.
I think you may be right.
I'm going to guess wife, spousal abuse, domestic violence.
Because he's so bitchy.
He's just so whiny.
Yeah.
If you ever want to see Johnny Cash, by the way, you can flip. We have new cameras floating around for the show now, so you can go to jcwshow.com, click on the live link, and you'll see the whole show. And, of course, it's up on YouTube later, so subscribe to our channel.
Did you know we had I've got like 500,000 views or 400,000 views on a stupid car bid last week. Did you see that, Tony?
Yeah, they love those car bids. They really do.
I know how to do that.
Well, it's entertaining. That's why. It's not your normal car bid. I mean, if you listen to the lightning round, every time there's something new that's going on where you're either arguing with somebody about a vehicle or you're bitching at them about their vehicle. One of the two.
Well, I'm just tired of people wanting too much for their cars. And then I'm paying too much and they're still being bitchy about it. Exactly. COVID is over. The deal's done. The market is still really, really, really high. Be really, really, really happy with what we're offering and stop complaining.
The one you got all the hits on this week, though, you said
RVs.
Something.
We buy RVs and ATVs, JD.
Really profound. You said something really profound and it stuck.
What did I say?
I can't remember. I mean, I love you. God loves you. But this car isn't special.
No, that's right.
That Something was so like that. Funny.
Yeah.
God still loves you, but your
God
car.
God bought a 1990 model or two, whatever, Monte Carlo SS Dale Earnhardt Edition pace car. You know, that's sticker, buddy. It's like a sticker. You go to Chief Auto Parts and buy you a decal pack and slap her on there. And now you've got you a Dale Earnhardt pace car. Yeah, and it's still a six-cylinder under the hood. It ain't nothing. It ain't a damn thing. There's nothing there.
There's people that buy those pace cars and think they were actually in the race, and they're just not. They're stickers.
The 1978 Corvette pace car still doesn't bring the right amount of money. They mass-produce pace cars.
Of course they do.
And Dale Earnhardt's dead. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO.
You know, there must be a glitch in the matrix with our Senate minority leader, Mitch McConnell. He froze up again. Did you guys see this?
Yeah.
It's just twice he's done this in the last month. Both times, it's just weird. It's eerie. He just freezes up. He stops. He stares into space like literally somebody pushed pause
blue
on
screen?
Him. Yeah, basically it's like, we're not making fun of him.
Funny, not funny.
We're
right.
not making fun of him. But this is actually a cut we have here, cut number one. This is what he might be thinking when that happens.
Who's the one that got caught in the bathroom being gay? Go ahead. I'll look it up during this.
Okay.
That's
what he's thinking.
Corn dog.
It could be. We're not
yeah.
sure.
Poor old Mitch.
What he's thinking. I know. It's just weird when he just freezes like that and just.
Wife beater shirts are now called wife pleasers.
Yeah.
How does that work?
I think that's a bad term. I'm offended. Wife beater. Well, that's not good. That's not nice.
Gen Z doesn't want to call those white tank tops wife beaters anymore, so they've come up with wife pleasers. Some of the other things were wife lovers, wife respecters. I don't know anybody that's ever worn one.
How about
of those.
Just a t-shirt?
There you go. GG, take us out.
Yeah, it's a t-shirt, and we'll be right back with more of the John Clay Wolfe Show, brought to you by America's best car buyer, GimmeTheVin.com. I hear hurricanes
blowing. The John Clay Wolfe Show. The number one weekend morning show in America. JohnClayWolfe.com.
Tastes good.
Hey, want more John Clay Wolfe? Go to JCWShow.com for the fastest growing podcast in the U.S.
50 seconds.
You need hit them up 800-800-RADIO and check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. Now John Clay Wolf.
Kimberly has a 2012 Yukon Denali with 200,000 miles. Damn, Kimberly, where have you been driving? Where have you been driving?
But like the Ozarks, and I drive back and forth to my family in Kansas and stuff.
Put it into givemethevin.com. Let me look at it on there. Load it into givemethevin.com. I'll buy it. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. I asked a question when you were talking about Mitch McConnell. Everybody frowned at me because I said, was he the dude in the gay bathroom? And what I meant was, do y'all remember that toe-tapping thing?
Yeah, that was... guy's named Larry Craig. He was a Republican for like 18 years, and he was from Idaho. And yeah, he was at the airport, St. Paul, Minneapolis, and he did the whole toe tap thing, which is kind of like, hey, you interested? And he got arrested for that. Up? Yeah. Basically, he paid $600 in court fees, and he was dropped.
Did he get a handy?
I don't know. I wasn't there, John. But
who else was gay bathroom people? George Michael, Pee Wee Herman, Hugh Grant. No, he was prostitute back alley. Yeah. Hugh Grant.
Yeah. Pee Wee Herman wasn't a gay bathroom.
He wasn't?
That was a theater.
No, he was by himself.
Adult theater.
Yeah.
Ought to be a safe space.
What is an adult theater?
An adult theater.
I mean, if you're in an adult theater and you're loping your mule, I mean, isn't that what people do in adult theater?
Isn't that why you're there?
It ought to be a safe space. I mean,
don't you walk in and get one ticket for you and one for your mule that you're leading in on a lead rope?
Yeah. Yeah.
I believe you do.
George Michael was a gay bathroom, wasn't he?
I thought he was like in a park somewhere.
Ty Herndon was in a park, a country singer. He got caught.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. On his way to a police charity event. Literally.
How about that?
Yeah.
What was he doing?
He was
Who's
in
Ty
a,
Herndon?
Ty Herndon's a country singer. He had a lot of hits in the 90s, and he's back doing hits now. But anyway, yes, he was stopped in a Dallas
was
park.
Was he hitting a boy or a girl in the park?
He hit up a Dallas police officer for a rendezvous in the bathroom, and he got arrested.
Was it a man?
Yes.
So Ty Herndon's queer?
Yes. He's gay.
Did he sing a song about that?
He did not. Not yet. I'm sure it's coming
Would
out.
Would that not sell well in the country world?
Didn't he get pulled
I'm
off?
I'm proud to be gay, and I like to go to
He got pulled off
public parks.
I worked at a country station when this happened. He got pulled off all the stations. Everybody just abandoned him.
That's I'm offended.
Yeah, sorry. I was in country radio.
If he did
at the
it
time.
Today, then they'd probably, you know,
they'd probably support
turn
him.
Up.
Yeah.
His new song is Phil, let me tell you what I'm talking about. Come and let me show you while I whip this out.
No, that's not his song.
Come on.
No, it's not his song.
Didn't
Eddie Murphy get arrested for?
Yes, he did.
For trying like a. Picking up a transsexual prostitute or something
Who did
like that?
That?
What?
Let me pull it up here. Hang on. Let me look. Yes. I hear it. 1997, Eddie Murphy was observed picking up a transgender prostitute named Shalimar Salui. She was arrested on outstanding warrants, but Murphy was let go. He claimed he was giving her a ride.
I bet he would.
I bet he was.
What a transgender lady. That was Grace Jones.
Gigi, you're a therapist. Do you have anybody ever come clean in therapy? Say, you know, don't tell my wife, but I'm gay.
Okay. Check this out, right? I was seeing this person individually, right?
Right.
And, it's long, 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 long time ago. Anyways, so the wife comes and, you know, there's confidentiality and stuff like that. So he says, you know, my wife is going to come in and to join the session. And she wanted to know, right? And he said, you can, any question she has, you can answer. And I will do that. You know what I mean? But I'm not going to tell. I'm going to answer a question.
Right.
So the wife wanted to know if he had ever told me that he was going and having sex with other women. The answer was no. She did not ask me if he was having sex with other men.
Oh.
The answer would have been yes.
Did y'all get that out in the therapy?
No, she didn't ask.
Yeah, but I mean, like, throughout the thing, did y'all ever come clean about all this?
That's all she wanted to know. That's all she wanted to know was he with other women? And once the answer was no, she was like, okay, well, continue with your individual session. She asked the wrong question.
I'll be damned.
Yeah, it happens.
I send my wife to the pharmacy to get my, when I got hurt, broke my back, got the spinal cord thing, I had to have blue pills to make things work.
Sure.
But I mean, once you get used to that, it's kind of nice. It's not like I need them, but like if you just bite a little bit of one off, like a third of it, it's like the difference between taking water and putting it in the freezer so it can get cold versus just putting ice in it. It's going to get cold immediately.
I get it.
It's lazy.
It's recreational. A lot of people have it for recreational reasons.
It makes me lazy. It just makes life easier. You don't have to work at anything. You don't have to think about it, especially if you've got whiskey D. So, but she's like, I'm not going to the pharmacy anymore to pick up your damn pills.
What?
Because like I'll say, hey, babe, I've got a prescription at the pharmacy. I won't tell her what it is. And they're like, oh, he's already out. Y'all have fun.
Oh, no.
Embarrassed her.
Wow.
Viagra.
Yeah, they've got cheap ones now.
Oh, do they knockoffs?
Yeah. Yeah, they're just with insurance. I mean, it's just nothing. I'd get y'all some. Y'all want some?
No, I'm good. Thanks.
I mean, I've been around a fairly representational cross-section of user types, and you don't strike me as that type at all.
It's just easy.
You've had a traumatic injury.
Right.
You know. Yeah. I've seen you step wrong on your, is it your right foot? Sometimes it's you like
it rolls over,
cross break, and you're like,
oh yeah. So my ankles don't work, my feet don't work. So right. Like my ankle roll over, and I have to save it often. 800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO. Hey, Lazy JD.
Yes,
Michael's trying to get your attention.
I know, I see it just now. Yeah, you want to see the show? We're on live right now. JCWShow.com. You can go click on the live YouTube app. Also, we buy RVs, we buy motorcycles, and we buy classic cars as well. Yes. Then you can go to the GiveMeTheVin.com website for that.
You sound so like unconvinced when you're delivering that. Can we try that again?
That wasn't very.
That was terrible.
No.
I thought, hey, if I'm going to get you this job for the deal that we're talking about, you're going to have to step it up.
Step up, yeah. Okay. Take two.
Three, two, one.
Hey, you guys want to see the show? We're on live right now. YouTube. It's an amazing thing. In fact, John is topless for his birthday. Go to jcwshow.com. Click on the live link. Also, if you want to sell your car or RV or motorcycle, we buy all those. It's GiveMeTheVin.com, and John is topless. And coming up next, Gigi will get topless. YouTube.com. Oh. Go away.
Got a black magic woman. I've got a black magic woman.
GiveMeTheVin.com is America's best car buyer for a reason. We don't sell your leads to anyone else like the rest of our competitors. You're our customer. We handle our customers right, and that's why we're America's best car buyer. You're not going to get harassed by a bunch of different people selling your information. GiveMeTheVin.com dominates. Why? Because we take care of our customers. They don't call me America's best car buyer for nothing.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVin.com.
The John Clay Wolfe Show is heard every week on great stations. Catch the nation's fastest growing podcast and live video stream at johnclaywolfe.com.
30 seconds.
When his condescending father-in-law calls his son an ignorant flat earther, he always replies angrily, "The correct term is ignorant dozer operator, prick." When his wife asked him how many women he'd slept with, he told her the truth. "Only you, darling. With all of the others, I was awake. Yes, I was." Though he's feeling truly melancholy about turning 51, he still occasionally claims to be 60. Mainly at restaurants, bars, and strip clubs offering a senior discount. Come to Papa. He is the world's biggest son of a bitch.
"Hey man, I don't always drink beer, but when I do, make mine a Natty Light Tall Boy. Yeah, buddy."
To the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Jimmy Buffett will not be doing the Labor Day weekend show in San Francisco this weekend. He has passed away. For you guys that just woke up and figuring out what happened yesterday, Jimmy Buffett is no longer with us.
Dead at 76.
Blenders are all off today.
Dark.
In honor of Jimmy Buffett.
Just sad. Died at 76. Healthy though, right up until the end.
Yeah.
Literally out surfing 2 months ago. He had concerts last month. He just put a brand new album out this week.
Yeah.
So luckily, he wasn't, people didn't plan on dying.
Luckily, he made away with the last Mango in Paris.
Ah, man. There's so many Jimmy Buffett songs, so little time.
Stephanie in Pennsylvania, good morning. You're on the air.
Hey, I just wanted to let you know your wife should be proud to pick up that prescription for you. Because at least you can keep up with her then.
This is true. Oh. This is true. Actually, yeah. It's the other way around. I'm the over user. If that's the right word.
Well, maybe you need to slip her some.
Does it work for women?
I don't know.
No, does it work for women? Does it get you? What does it do? What does Viagra do to women?
That I couldn't tell you.
How old are you, Steph?
Maybe you need to find her something.
Oh, she's fine. There's
45.
No problem there. Huh? You're 45? I see that you live,
yep.
You live in Pennsylvania. Where in Pennsylvania?
East of Pittsburgh.
Okay, cool. WDBE. Good morning, Pittsburgh. Thank you, Stephanie. Hey, we've been up there. How long have we been on in Pittsburgh now? Has it been a year?
Yeah.
Something like that? Steph, when you first heard us, did you hate us and then we snuck up on you and you liked us?
No, actually, I liked you from the first time I heard you.
Well, that's nice. That normally doesn't happen like that.
Rare.
What but age did you lose your virginity?
It must have been the Viagra. All right. 800-800-7234.
800-800-7234. Study steps shown Viagra may provide benefits for women having difficulty in that area since it raises blood flow.
Speaking of late nights, Charlie, what were you... So last night, I have friends out here from high school. It's like the city team from Married with Children. My friends from our high school football team were out here dove hunting. And we were up late, sitting on the porch. And one of them came in. It was like 1 in the morning. He's like, "Who the hell's out there in a Corolla walking around?" I'm like, "I don't know. Did you shoot him?" He's like, "No." And he's like, "I'm telling you, somebody's out there in a Corolla." I'm like, "It must be Turley." Because Turley drives different cars every week. But I didn't think you were coming out last night. I thought you were coming in this morning.
No. I drive in even after a late football game, getting in about 1 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
And all of a sudden, pull up, and some guy randomly is grabbing some beers out of a cooler. Says,
"It won.
Who are you?" I go, "Mike Turley." All right. And so then I'm like hearing this background noise gets louder and louder as I walk towards the door, and it's just a full-on drinking party. The first thing I hear, one of somebody's friends says, man, the best sex I ever had was with so-and-so. I'm like, oh, my God. I was like, they're so loud. I'm like, I think I'm going to turn around and just go down to the studio and sleep there because there's going to be no way I'm going to get any sleep there.
So you're saying somebody did not observe the new curfew?
No.
Because there, I remember there was an imposed curfew last week.
11:30.
When I dared to have a little fun on a Friday night.
This was 1 o'clock.
It was 11 p.m., John, I think was the curfew.
I always curfew myself at 11, but last night, since it is... It's your turn. Well, it's my turn, but it is Labor Day weekend, and I found out Jimmy Buffett passed away, so I was like figuring I need to stay up for him.
First of all, that wasn't announced until this morning.
How do you know?
Because I was there. I was listening to Radio Margarita when they announced it.
Do you think it's the first place they announced it?
Maybe yes.
Maybe I have better Jimmy Buffett hookups than you have.
You probably do. It's your birthday, and it's your ranch. Do what you want.
And it's Labor Day weekend. So, yeah, it was loud last night. You know, it was funny how people get to talking. And one of the guys, I'm not going to say who because I don't want to embarrass him, but he admitted that he used one of our other teammates' pictures on his Bumble account.
What?
He's catfishing.
Ah. Oh.
Like a face picture?
Yes.
Okay.
So on his dating app account, he used another guy's face.
So this is the ugly one. So we know which one it is.
No, he's not ugly at all.
That's not the ugly one.
Actually, he's a better looking guy, in my opinion. Not that I have a strong guy attractive opinion, but I mean, I think he'd get more gals with his face than the other guy's face. But he just didn't want to be out there. But God, we were just laughing about that so hard. How did the date go? You know, and he's like, oh, it's all right. You know, but she. Mexican girls tasted like a Mexican corn dog.
God.
I'm like, what?
Stop everything.
Intimate racist moments with John Clay Wolfe.
Thanks for joining us today, everyone. Yeah.
Brought to you by You Can't Say That.
Hey, if you want to see our YouTube channel go dark, go to jcwshow.com and click on the YouTube link.
He's not a hater. He's a Texan.
Olay.
He's the accidental racist.
I've never had a Mexican corn dog. Does that have like a little corn and jalapeno in it?
No one's helping you out.
Hey,
not at all. This
week in flashbacks, we're going to do Tony Romo's dad.
Oh, isn't that a great deal?
Do we have time for it?
Yeah, we've been doing this a lot. We've had a lot of responses over these. I don't know if this counts as an actual viral video, but it did go to video later. Years ago, on this program, when Tony Romo was injured during the NFL's 2016 preseason, we had the idea of doing him as a character on the show, Turley and I. And during that week, I was really sweating it because he wasn't a sportscaster. We had no idea what Tony Romo sounded like when he talked.
Oh, that's right.
So I did a lot of research, and Turley and I talked every day about this that week. Yeah. And I found out Tony Romo's dad is second-generation Mexican-American.
Does he taste like a Mexican corn dog?
And his mom is German-Polish. So I called Turley, and I said, I know what we do. We don't talk to Tony Romo. And he didn't believe it. He had to look it up, too. We don't talk to Tony Romo, we talk to his dad. And the fact that his dad is Mexican-American and his mother is German-Polish is the reason that Tony Romo is so accident-prone. And so we introduced a new character. And it really is his actual name, Ramiro Romo. And this is the first time we did it back in 2016. Cut number 10.
Hello, Mr. Romo.
Hola.
What?
I am Antonio Ramiro Romo.
I hate to bring this up. Tony Romo's not Spanish.
Yes, he is.
No, he's not.
Yes, yeah. He's my son.
Well, he's not.
My grandfather comes from Coahuila.
No,
that's a hot sauce.
But his mother is German Polish.
No.
This is why he's so accident prone. No. For many years now. It's only by the love of the Virgin Mother Mary that he's had no head injuries. But he has worn a helmet since he was 4 years old. My son, Ramiro Jr., learned to throw the football from throwing wild animals.
No. No. No, I don't think that's...
First we see him throw a dog. Throw him 48 yards.
At what age did you know you had a football star in your hands?
He used to do it all the time.
No.
We used to call that the long dog.
Once many years ago, he threw a possum.
He's never abused animals by throwing them.
He threw this possum around the corner of our garage, 61 yards. He is very good, but he fall down all of the time. No. He once poked himself with a knife and fork in his left eye. Many people in the league do not realize my son Tony have a glass eye on the left side. This is why he always spin to the right out of the pocket.
Dumb that was.
Tony Romo has a glass eye.
That's why he comes out of the pocket to the right.
He threw animals all over the place.
And you'll remember that was a bit of a hit for us way back when. Oh, and we did that bit. We had Ramiro Romo on the show every week for like 60 consecutive weeks.
Yeah, it was a long time.
After the season, through the season, Tony Romo gets a job. After Dak Prescott got the job, Tony Romo was like working at Taco Bell, and he could throw the chilito.
He throws something.
The chili cheese burrito, 112 yards.
In a high, tight spiral. 800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO. Call in now during the song. I'm going to bid your cars on the air in just a moment. We're coming into the part of the hour where I do the car bids called the lightning round, where I bid your car to buy it for America's best car buyer. Give me the VIN, like give me the VIN.com. That's the name of the company. Give me the VIN.com. Call in now, 800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO, and give them year, make, model, miles, average, rough, or clean, and I'll take you to the air, and we'll try to make a dope deal on the radio right now. Be right back.
Not look like it.
Listening.
We are actually kind of hip.
To the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Why does it have to be so loud?
And check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com.
Check. Mike. Check, 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 check. Why is it so damn hot? Check. Check, check, 1, 2. Hey, 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 hey. One, two, there he goes. A little bit better. 1, 2, 4, 3, 8, 10. 1, 6, 8. All over God's world. You can't remember when you got your last meal. And you don't know just how a woman feels. You didn't know what rock and roll was. 1, 2, hey, 3, 1, 2, and 1. Much better, I think. Hello, 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 hello. Sean to fix this.
Twice.
Now, back to the John Clay Wolfe Show, presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Hit him up right now, 1-800-800-RADIO, 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
And this is the lightning round where I bid cars to buy for GiveMeTheVin.com. John in Tallahassee, Florida, what do you got? John.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're on the air.
Well, I've been sitting listening to your show, but I heard y'all talk something about taking some kind of blue pills for men to help, you know, help better with sex.
Yeah.
I thought I heard him offer to give some out. I'd like to get some of them.
Okay. Hey, Pre-K, grab John on line one and line three and send him some hard-on pills.
No, you can't do that, John.
The show.
Sylvia in Fort Worth, good morning. Do you want some too?
Hi.
Hey.
What's up?
Do you want some blue pills too with your car bid?
Do what?
Nothing. 17 Volvo inscription, S60, T5, 44,000 miles. Average rough or clean?
Clean.
15 grand. Robert, San Antonio. 66 Chevy C10. 70,000 miles.
Yes, sir.
Has it been restored?
Not fully restored. Redid the bumpers. Re-chromed the both bumpers. The grill. A windshield washer plate is chrome.
Is it four-wheel drive?
We repainted it, we did all the cancer on it, but it's starting to come back.
You know what I'm sick of is, and I'm not pointing at you, but this is going to feel like I'm yelling at you. But what I'm sick of is these Jake legs redoing these cars and not taping off or removing the door rubbers when they do it. I've got three cars out here in my barn, the collectibles, where like full resto repaint, and there's overspray on the windows and the door handles and the little stuff. It's so dumb. Why are people so stupid? Why do they do that? Do they not understand what I'm talking?
You know what? The painter I had was actually pretty good. We just kind of slowed the project down, but the next thing was the upholstery and the reseals and all that stuff, and of course, time and my payment plate. We're gonna leave that for a while. I just let it there, and it's kind of, I give it to my son, and my son's still kind of yes, no, but it's sitting there. It runs.
Hey, just load it into GiveMeTheVin.com, but I think it's more like 6 grand the way you're talking, not 15. John in Pensacola, 01 Sonoma with big miles. It's probably worth, I don't know, $1,000, $1,500? 2 grand, $2,500?
About $1,000.
Yeah, I mean, it's 150,000 miles, a little mini truck. I need to see it. Go to GiveMeTheVin.com and load the pictures up. Sylvie, I'm going to have somebody call you, okay?
Okay.
01 Pontiac Grand Am. Shawnee there?
Yes.
In the mobile home park, how many miles are on it?
124,000.
It says restored. So you have a 01 Grand Am, and y'all got high on meth and restored it. So how many friends do you have there at the mobile home park?
Mobile home. I have a house, but I have
Let's assume some of the guys that helped you restored it live in a mobile home park. Can you get six guys and put them together?
Sure.
All right. So if you'll do this, take that 01 Pontiac Grand Am and pull it up at the mobile home park, go around the corner, find the big dumpster, and your buddies, bring them beer for helping you. Have your buddies all get on one corner like your pallbearers at a funeral, and y'all pick that piece of crap up and throw it in the dumpster. And video it. I'll send you $300.
Okay.
All right, thanks. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. My name's John Clay Wolfe. Buy cars on the radio for America's best car buyer. Give me the VIN.com.
Why do meth when you have the John Clay Wolfe Show?
The John Clay Wolfe Show.
No one knew where he came from.
But everybody wanted what he was selling.
Check out the podcast.
He was just some hillbilly who got on a plane and then just landed somewhere.
Please beware. The voice in your head is a threat.
JCWShow.com or JohnClayWolfe.com.
Levin. The John Clay Wolfe Show. America's largest weekend morning show. 800-800-RADIO. Here we go! Check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com.
No one. We do buy RVs and motorcycles and ATVs also at givemethevin.com. Hey, there's a... I just shared it on my Twitter. My Twitter handle's at John Clay Wolfe. So you can find this here. But there's this dude, Club Pro Guy. That is his Twitter handle.
Mm-hmm.
He is funny. And he's put together this thing called the Second Hole Foundation for divorced women that, like, had rich husbands and they're now divorced and can't maintain their old lifestyle.
Oh.
It's sad. So, like, I'm looking at this Twitter post right now. It says, meet Angie Caldwell. Angie's husband, Tim, recently left her because he claimed she had an online shopping addiction and wasn't faithful in the marriage. But thanks to a grant made possible by the Second Hole Foundation, Angie recently bought two new Coach handbags.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, God.
And he did this PSA for the Second Hole Foundation. It'll background the entire movement and the cause. Play that, Turley.
Women are losing access every day to private and semi-private golf clubs. Good-looking, middle-aged women. But with your prayers and a financial contribution of $59, we can save them. For the cost of a $59 cup of coffee, you can sponsor one of these women and help provide them with essential life-saving needs, such as reduced club dues, discounted group lessons, and two-for-one cocktails in the men's grill.
7 months of marriage and a country club membership gone. Like that.
Losing custody of our kids, that was one thing. I can deal with that. But losing the golf membership due to a divorce, that was unthinkable.
Will you make a difference in a divorced woman's life today? Click the link or go to isupportthesecondhole.com.
Thank you, Second Hole. Thank you, Second Hole.
God bless the Second Hole.
Sweet. If y'all want to see that, go to my Twitter feed, at John Clay Wolfe. Good morning, everyone. Happy Labor Day. Sad news, Jimmy Buffett has passed away. For those of y'all who just woke up and haven't realized that, he is no longer with us. 76.
76, man. I'm blown away. Not very many artists stop me. I just go, wow, really? What? Because he just put out a new album. He's doing so well. And then gone.
You literally walked in and said,
that's the first thing I said. I'm in mourning. Yeah, I was like, I can't believe it. Of all the people I just think the world of, Jimmy Buffett, I thought would be around to 90.
That's a big one, man.
How many Buffett shows have you gone to?
Probably less than 20. Probably 15, 20, 17, something like that.
That's a lot.
Yeah,
that's a lot.
Back in my drinking days, most of them are a blur. Oh, boy.
I bet you somebody listening right now has been to 40 Buffett shows.
How many have you bought tickets? This is a good. How many have you bought tickets to and not made it in because you're too drunk? And my answer is two.
Hey, you know what? I'll do a contest. Go to the JCW show. Click our YouTube channel, which is streaming the video of the show right now. And, I mean, this is dumb almost because people are just going to lie. But don't lie. How about that?
Don't lie.
Whoever says... Tell us on the chat deal on the side of the video screen at jcwshow.com how many Buffett shows you've been to, and whoever's the highest count will send a show shirt and the swag.
So go into the Wolf Den chat room and say, just all you got to say is how many shows you've been to.
Yeah, but don't lie. It's Labor Day and it's Jimmy Buffett's death. Don't lie.
Don't lie.
And then you'll win. Just don't lie. 800-800-7234, 800-800-7, whatever the number is, who cares? 84 Chevy, a square body truck, 60,000 miles. Hey, Randy, is it a short bed or long bed?
Long bed, 3/4 ton. Original paint, grandpa's kind of truck, you know.
Grandpa bought a rubber. You remember that?
Yes.
Steve Martin. Randy, load it into givemethevin.com. Let me take a look at it. Take pictures of the bad places. Don't catfish me. Don't lie. Okay? All right. 800 Southern California. Good morning, California. 800-800-RADIO. We've got You Just Lost a Listener right now. This is my favorite part of the show.
The favorite part is when people tell you how much they hate you.
Yes.
You just lost a listener.
Y'all remember we were talking about pickleball?
Everybody remember pickleball? Pickleball. Pickleball. Yeah,
this guy's from Burbank, California. He thinks you're a poser. I caught your little program this last Saturday. Hilarious to hear you guys talk about pickleball. Like you have any idea what it takes to be a real pickleball player. You guys think it's some geriatric club. I met some of the most athletic men I've ever known at pickleball tournaments. I'd love to see you come out and try to keep up with us. Just like football or baseball, this sport takes dedication and hard work to be a champion. I miss when true pickleballers played for the love of the sport and competition, but ever since the big money has gotten involved, it's a joke, just like jerks like you. Get pickled, John. This is George Ellison. I know, right? He's with the 2X... or two times, whatever.
He's the second hole in the second hole foundation.
Minor league pickleball state champion in Burbank, California, George Ellison.
I was waiting to see if he was
just lost a listener.
A George or a Janet, because I play pickleball with all the guys.
Oh my God, we have George here with us right now. George from Burbank, good morning. Happy Labor Day weekend, George.
If you think you know pickleball, you don't know pickle. You're in a pickle. That's funny.
What's your favorite part of pickleball? Do you have one?
I like the cucumbers.
Oh, no, they're not really cucumbers involved.
I slice them up and put them on a salad.
Oh.
Make it healthy. Because you have to play pickleball.
What is your pickleball schedule during the week?
Every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at 2 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and 9 o'clock at night. We play lights out pickleball.
Lights out?
Have you ever played lights out pickleball?
No.
You don't even need a paddle.
What do you do?
We have a new variation called find the wiffle ball.
Find the wiffle.
And one of the guys will hide it, and then we have to find it. And nobody hides it on him.
Oh, they don't hide it on them.
I know, and we all get blindfolded. He says, nope, not there. Find the pickleball.
Gotcha. You're so nice in person, but your letter to us was so rude.
I know, I can be such a bitch when I write letters.
Yeah? Because
I'm out of Viagra.
Oh, no, Viagra.
Oh, that makes it hard on a pickleball player.
Did you listen to Bobo's Gay House story last week on the radio?
Yes.
What did you think about that?
I don't think I could live with him.
You what?
I don't think I could live with him.
Couldn't live with him.
Doesn't he drink?
Yes.
That's not cool. You can't play pickleball if you drink.
Oh.
Most of them are in bars.
I know. We had a guy named Charlie that tried to play in our pickleball league, and we lost 14 games in a row.
Oh.
And that's only 2 days worth. And we're so mad. We're all mad. And we showed up at his house at 1:30 in the morning.
Why?
And he was having a party. And all of his friends were in drag. And they were ugly.
Ugly.
We're all pretty.
You are pretty, man.
Pretty.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Burbank. Ugly. Burbank pickleballer.
They don't know how to wear lipstick over there.
Where?
No whipple wall for you.
Whipple.
Homie.
You sound fat and gay.
Wow.
Sorry, Dad.
Australian lady, they pulled a 3-inch worm out of her brain.
Oh, God.
What?
Out.
Ew.
It's the weirdest story, yeah. This is doctors in Australia had screened and scanned and tested this woman to find out what was wrong with her. She was like lethargic. She was having problems with her abdominal pains and diarrhea, all kinds of things. And they finally looked in her and they found a 3-inch red worm living in her brain. The weird part is these particular worms grow in and around pythons. She lives next door to a python farm. So what happened was one of the snakes apparently pooped this out, and she went out and gathered greens to eat. So greens killed her pretty much.
Was she dead?
Eggs? No, she lived through this. The eggs are ingested by small mammals, and the worms can grow inside you and then get into your brain in Australia. True story.
Not in Florida?
True story. This happened to be in Australia.
No, you're wrong, Mike.
I know I am. That's why I just waved it off.
That's what happens when you're an alcoholic.
Right.
Right. We got the Australian man. Good morning, Australian man. Australian man. We've got to go to break. I don't have much time for you, sir.
Last thing you want to do is catch the deadly brine worm.
Oh, is that what
the
that
brine
is?
Worm gets in your brain.
Oh.
And you can't laugh. You can't sing. You're trying not to do anything. You can't smile.
No smiling.
With the brain worm. It's bad.
It's bad.
Really bad.
Gordon Boswell's Flowers is a sponsor of the show. You go to jcwshow.com and click their link. Around the corner or across the country, Gordon Boswell is your hookup. Like I hooked Gigi up with some Gordon Boswell flowers.
They were so beautiful. They were so nice.
They do a good job. They're not the cheap ones. So if you're on a budget, it's probably not for you. But if you want the good stuff, Gordon Boswell's is your hook. My name's John Clay Wolfe. This show is also brought to you by America's Best Car Buyer. GiveMeTheVIN.com. If GiveMeTheVIN does not beat a written CarMax offer, and you just send them a picture of it and they don't beat it, they'll send you a check for $100. Pretty easy. Be right back.
It's Gigi from the John Clay Wolfe Show. Do you want the most money for your used car? Do you want a hassle-free process? Of course you do. Give Me the VIN will beat your written CarMax offer or write you a check for $100. It's that simple. Give Me the VIN is A-plus rated by the BBB and thousands of online reviews. Get an instant cash offer and the most money for your used car right now at GiveMeTheVIN.com. America's best car buyer.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com.
Listening to the most popular Saturday morning show to ever broadcast in America. You're listening to the John Clay Wolfe Show. Feel free to call and make your voice heard. 800-800-RADIO. If you missed any of the show, go to jcwshow.com right now and download the podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show.
John Clay Wolfe. I don't even know how old he is.
51 maybe?
Yeah.
Yeah. Pack.
Pre-K, I had a customer complain about your voicemail.
Come on, man. I'm just trying to do my thing. What are these customers complaining about?
You want to tell everybody what's going on here?
Yeah, I mean, here's Pre-K's voicemail.
What it do? This is DJ Pre-K with GimmeTheVin.com. I got your car, and I want to buy that thing. And our process is easy like a $2 hoe.
You can't say hoe in a voicemail.
That's how we talk down here, man. You know, I want to buy that hoe.
That is not how we talk, man.
I'm thinking about changing the jingle. Man. So easy that it's just like a $2 hoe.
There we go.
The John Clay Wolfe Show. Every Saturday morning. Give me the Vin! The John Clay Wolfe Show.
Wolf, happy birthday. That must be pretty special for you.
Why is that special? Why should that be special? We're long past the 5-0. Did you know, think yours was special?
But it's a number. It's not for him. It's
they're
a
all
deal.
Numbers. What
take
does
it
that
out
mean?
Of your body, Mr. Actor Pants.
Mean?
Make it about him. Make it about him. Take forget about you for
so
a minute.
So you think it's exciting for John? All right, let's look at it through John's eyes.
Special message here to us,
John,
from Jason Alexander.
Couldn't be happier that you're 51. May you also hit 52, and after that, we'll talk. After that, we'll talk. But you hit 50, and that's a milestone. Right, Peter? Yours is coming up.
That seems so condescending. That was
which
so
means to talk down to.
I think give him some happiness. Give him some joy. What a great
all
guy
right.
is. How
here,
you enjoyed
here, I'm
meeting
sing,
him.
I'm
nice
going to sing
was,
it this way. I'm going to do a
sitting
special.
Sitting tobacco thing. Whatever you want to bring
special
up.
Special birthday song.
Don't bring up the
John
tobacco.
Brother. Ready?
Right. Yeah.
Here it is. Happy birthday. It's your birthday. Death, destruction, and despair. People dying everywhere. It's your birthday. Happy birthday.
Much better. Happy birthday, John.
Broadcasting live from the Wolfe Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolfe Show. From coast to coast, the largest weekend morning show heard all across America. Los Angeles, Houston, Dallas, Nashville, San Diego, Las Vegas, Denver, New Orleans, Oklahoma City, Austin, and available to the rest of the world at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Gigi, did you hear that the liberals or whomever, the offended, are wanting to remove the word breastfeeding?
Please stop.
And they want to call it chest.
It's too early for this stupidity.
They want to call it chest feeding.
Like chesticles, like my 24-year-old daughter used to say, Mommy, Mommy, am I going to get some chesticles? Stupid.
Why do they want
it's
to
breast.
Change it?
The milk comes from the breast. I'm sorry if that's offensive.
Yeah. No, that's a clinical term. That's from. A correct clinical term. Why do they want to change it?
You know, they just want to change everything.
Somebody's feelings are hurt because they don't have breasts. They can't breastfeed. And so because they don't have breasts and they can't breastfeed, then they're saying nobody can say breastfeed.
But women have breasts.
And they also, during the football game, there was an announcer that was talking about a guy that juked everybody on the field in a touchdown. And the same people that are offended about that said they were offended that he said he beat off all 11 guys to make a touchdown.
Well, didn't he?
800-800-7234-800-800-RADIO.
Turley's disgusted.
Are you disgusted, Turley?
Your dad jokes are so bad.
Are they?
They're so bad.
I try.
Gigi didn't even get it. She's so blonde.
She's so dumb.
Shut up. No.
If you
want to
get laid, just give Gigi 2 beers and tell her you love her.
One beer. Just tell me you like me a lot. Here, take my panties. Take them, please. But no, the thing with breastfeeding, right? I think that's great. It's, you know, breast milk for the babies and stuff like that. But back when I was nursing my youngest, I nursed her for a long time. They started this thing where you just whip your breast out in public, just right. Like, whoo, there it is. You know what I mean? I'm feeding my kid. And that's uncomfortable for me. And I'm a woman, so I can imagine if, I don't know, maybe guys like it or stuff. So there's a lot of issues
maybe
around.
Guys like what? Maybe guys like
maybe
boobs?
Guys like
maybe
watching
you're right.
Women whip their breast out to breastfeed their babies. And but, you know, so.
Everybody in the room, you can see it on video, raise your hand if you like to see women whip their breast out for any reason at all.
Where's the maybe come from? There ain't no maybe about it.
Our Dolly Parton's
well, never
boob
mind.
Grill.
Hey, Dustin, do you have an 07 Land Cruiser or FJ Cruiser with 170 on it?
Yes.
4-inch lift. You want 15,000 for it? Is that right?
Yeah.
I think I can make that. I bet I can make that work.
Okay.
Where do you live?
Ucaipa.
Where the hell's that?
By Big Bear, Redland.
Oh, okay, so you're
in California.
California, baby.
So he's a smoker. He's a. Or do you do smoke or edibles?
I just smoke right now.
There you go, man. Yeah. He's good. Right on. Here's Dustin getting right, making it easy to do business. He's calm, cool, licked a little bit high. He just sold us his car. He didn't even realize it yet. He's going to go out and do a little mountain climbing, smoke some more. Good for you, Dustin.
Growing it. That's what I'm doing.
Oh, he's growing it, too.
Oh, wow.
You're all over it. All right, Dustin.
That's where I'm at. I'm at work.
Go to givemethevin.com and load it up and say, John bought this one from me on the radio for 15 grand. Let's roll. Thank you.
Sell that bitch!
That was so nice of George Costanza to give me a birthday. That's funny. Yeah. Hey, James, you there? James in Kingsville, you're on the air.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Good. You're a badass, dude.
What do you mean?
You're awesome.
Oh, I thought you were mad at me.
You know, you're awesome.
Well, thanks.
You're great.
See, Gigi, listen to him.
Yeah.
I'm listening.
He tells me opposite of what you tell me. You're always beating me down.
You're damn right.
Right. I mean, don't let those women beat you up, guys.
And you're not a hater, so you're a badass.
Thank you, sir. John, you have a 69 Z28 with 300 miles on a new engine. You want $85,000 for it, and it's your cousin's car. Why didn't your cousin call in?
I don't know. He's shy about all stuff.
He's not shy about the price.
Not at all.
No. Tell your cousin to kiss my ass.
He's got like 7 or 8 cars that he's rebuilt, but this is one of them that I just absolutely think it's great. So
I think he's 20.
It's the yellow one.
I think he's 20,000 high.
It's the yellow one with the black stripe down the middle and
69 Camaro Z28 restored, great condition. I'll give 65,000 for it.
Wow.
No, he wants 85, so I'll re.
Doug, SoCal. Hummer.
Yeah.
08 Hummer with 100 on it. You want 30 grand for it? It's worth 20.
25?
20. Bitch is all miled out, okay. Man. I mean, come on. It's not like it's got 40 on it. It's got 100. It's a Hummer. It's mass-produced. It's okay. It's cool. But it ain't that cool. It's just, you know, it's like a pair of fake boobs with lumps in them. You're like, oh, look at that. They're big. And then you're like, oh, I really don't like it. Put them back.
I don't know, John. You've been around this thing, but I've never had a bad Hummer.
Doug?
Yeah.
20 grand.
I'll think about it.
Yeah, I will too. I might change. I'm tired of these son of a bitches and their high prices.
Apparently you are.
They're trying to drive up inflation and I'm fighting to bring it back down.
God bless you, John Clay Wolfe.
Hey, you know the doctor I told you, the friend of mine?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have him on the next segment when we come back.
Okay.
About the cancer and the fellatio. Is that the correct term?
Yes, that's okay, yes.
So what was it again? Reset for everybody?
He claims that he's a cancer doctor. And that performing oral on your gal could make your head blow off with cancer.
No.
Have you ever seen, Gigi, did you ever see that movie, The Mask? The Rocky
I haven't seen
Rocky with the bit in Cher? You never saw
that? I know what you're talking about, though.
Rocky.
Oh, no, I did see that, The Mask.
That's what he says your face will turn into if you're.
Oh, stop it.
It's not true.
Stop it. You can't say that.
If you want to see the show, by the way, we are on live on YouTube. We brought some new cameras in. It's kind of fun. Go to jcwshow.com and click on the live link. While you're there, if you would subscribe and like us, that'd be very cool, too. And if you want to buy, by the way, we're also buying RVs and motorcycles and all kinds of good stuff. That's givemethevin.com.
Jimmy Buffett passed away because he ate too much Pinocchio.
That's true. True story.
We'll be right back. And if we lose you, because we're switching time zones right now, just go to jcwshow.com and click the video stream right there. In the Wolf Den chat room is on the right. Y'all can rag on me there. We'll be right back.
The John Clay Wolf Show is heard every week on great stations. Catch the nation's fastest growing podcast and live video stream at johnclaywolf.com. And we'll be back with more of the John Clay Wolfe Show right after this.
your vows. Give up your vows. Save our city. Save our city. And now.
You get a shiver in the dark. It's raining. Sound of the river, you're stopping your whole everything.
Test, test, 1, 2. Testing, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, I just wanted to be, didn't know if you want two people. Just want one, never mind.
Guess Mike.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1
Competition in other places. But the horns, they blowing that sound. Way on down south. Way on down south, London town. Check out Guitar George. Strictly rhythm, he doesn't want to make it cry or sing. If any old guitar is all he can't afford, when he gets up under the lights to play his bass.
sultans. We are the sultans of swing.
Cent almost stole my life.
Tell that story.
I was at the Super Bowl. We were at the party, and he came out on stage, and she was just like mesmerized. We were right there at the stage, and he started talking to her, and I thought, you know, that moment where you like feel like you're losing
her. You're about to lose her.
It was weird.
He was looking at her, too.
She just got
starstruck. She's beautiful.
Starstruck.
She got starstruck.
Yeah. We'll take care of her, man.
You don't worry about it. We'll show her the bus.
800-800-723 for my name is John Clay Wolfe. Remember, you can go to the jcwshow.com and click the video feed, and the cameras in the studio are working. Hey, good. Come here. My friends, this is my birthday weekend, so my friends are out here at the ranch with us. And
get all your buddies. Come
on right here. And dove hunting weekend, opening college football weekend. It's just a good weekend. Do you have your headphones?
I don't have any headphones.
JD, will you get him? I thought you said... Right, this is...
It's not the first time I've been told
that.
That's
odd, because you look like a headphone time.
So, last night, you guys stayed up until what time? Because I went to bed at 1:30, and y'all kept talking.
Last time I went to bed was Thursday. What's today?
Today is Saturday morning. It is Labor Day weekend.
We're doing
and Jimmy
great.
Buffett died this morning. Did you know that?
Yeah, that's great. That's sad.
You haven't been to bed since... So, you guys didn't go to bed last night?
We didn't.
You really, like, did you stay out there on the porch all night?
All night.
Because I heard you at 5:30. Y'all were getting ready. Y'all want to go hunting before the sun came up. Did y'all shoot any birds this
morning?
Three
birds this morning.
Yeah?
5:30 was the restart. Yeah, for sure.
And what are you fueling this?
That was a Bloody Mary at 5:30.
You're fueling this run with Bloody Marys?
Well, vodka Red Bull to about 10:30.
Last night?
It's all good. No, 10:30 this morning.
Okay, so Bloody Marys and vodka Red Bull is
that was at 5:30, yeah.
Okay.
And these men have weapons?
Shot three birds.
Yeah.
Clean the birds. Back to the house. Make some eggs.
Eggs?
Bacon. Vodka Red Bull.
What's next?
What time is it?
It is it's 11. Well, it's different time zones, different places.
We're doing great.
And you're 50?
51.
All right. Congratulations on that.
Thank you very much.
So you're just charging right through it, just like you're a teenager again. So we're back here with
what
our
else
old high,
are we gonna do,
our high school friends. These guys are my high school football teammates, and they're out here, and you haven't been to bed yet since Thursday.
Thursday.
Hey!
That wasn't me. Don't look at me.
All right. Do you have any health issues? You're worrying me.
I feel great.
Okay.
I could probably use a Triscuit, maybe.
Triscuit?
I feel like there's going to be some things later.
Yeah.
At 51.
Okay. I don't know what that
processing
means.
Processing problems, probably.
Oh, you need to clean your system.
Not a lot of vegetables. A
little Metamucil.
I know exactly where you're coming from, Messi.
He knows.
Well, I'm glad that you're good. That's why your name is Hey Good.
Solid.
And then we're going to, after the show, we're going to keep this rolling, watch football, keep drinking Bloody
Marys. You
want
me to take us out?
No, we're not. We have 7 minutes left before we take it. But what I
Good
do
job.
Want to, I want to bring, so we were talking about, wait, we have a fact check. Don, could you grab that mic? Fact check. Richard, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
What's your fact check, sir?
No, the first thing I want to say is I want to wish you a happy birthday.
Thank you.
Party on. I love you.
Thank you.
But the fact check is when you said fellatio, mm-hmm. fellatio is actually a woman performing oral sex on a man. Cunnilingus is oral sex performed by a man on a woman.
Okay.
Well,
I'm going to get you. I'm going to get you some more details right now. Thank you.
He's a very cunning linguist.
Okay. Okay. Making sure.
You're 100% correct, by the way.
You got to get.
Which one mic is
the Yeah, you got to talk right in the end of that mic. So, Dr. Don.
You're 100% correct, by the way.
And doctor, you are a doctor, cancer doctor.
That is correct.
How many years?
Going on 17.
17. You got to stay in that mic. Sorry about that. 17 years, and you work on cancer patients, do all kinds of cancer, and you were telling us last night while we were cocktailing that cunnilingus makes you get cancer?
It is a risk factor for cancer if your partner happens to be infected with HPV. So,
Don, I hate to do this to you. Swap him. Hey,
it's not
sit
exactly
down.
What he said.
That mic's screwing up. You're going to have to dump those. You're going to have to take those. There you go. Yeah. The microphone over there is screwing up. So, okay, so this is a better microphone for you. So it increases your HPV?
HPV is everywhere, okay? It's the same organism that causes cervical cancer. It causes some other cancers. But in approximately 70% of men who get head and neck cancer is caused by HPV. It is a risk factor from, as your guest says, cunnilingus.
So like when you're interviewing your guy, you ask him how many times he helps out his gal? I mean, is it like one shot you've been bitten by the vampire, or is it a matter of exposure?
It's a matter of exposure, and it's really hard to quantify what it actually is. I mean, the good news is for our children is that there's vaccines for them, and so the CDC recommends that everyone between 11 and 26, whether you're male or female, gets vaccinated to the HPV. It prevents cervical cancer in women. It prevents head and neck cancer in both men and women.
Is it too late for me to get the vaccine?
Talk to your doctor about your risk factors.
Well, you're my doctor.
I would suggest
now
you get,
you are. I don't
suggest
have a
you
doctor.
Get vaccinated. Usually the CDC says cut off at 45 if you have exposure and perhaps you're not in a monogamous situation. The vast majority of people will clear this HPV infection on their own. So even if you're exposed to it, in a year or two, it'll be gone. It won't be causing any problems. But you really cannot predict the folks that'll have persistent disease that can lead to changes that may or may not cause cancer.
Real quick, while we have you on the phone, and we have some guys at 50, is that when you're supposed to get the big butt exam?
It's moved to 45.
Okay.
So we've gone backwards a little bit on that. We've seen, especially in men, that the disease has started presenting earlier, and the big butt thing he's talking about is colonoscopy.
I've been scheduled for it four times and I never show up.
Yeah, that's bad. You need to do that. So 45 years old.
You want to do me right now on the radio?
Oh, God.
Ooh,
no.
Yeah.
You're probably not prepped appropriately. No. We got to have a clean runway, if you know what I mean.
Okay. I don't want any. I don't want to give you HPV.
I do not want to experience that. So 45 years old, to answer his question, is the actual age. So men, women out there, if you're listening, get screened. That's one of the preventable cancers that we can control. Mm-hmm. And 45 years old for colonoscopy.
Did you know when the guy went to the proctologist and his hand up in the big butt doing the thing, and then he pulled his hand out and he put a glove on his other hand and he went up again on the left hand, and the patient asked the doctor, why did you switch hands? Do you know the answer?
I do not.
Because I thought you might want a second opinion.
Dad jokes, still
dad
bad.
Dad jokes, right here, yep. 800-800-7234. Now we have Johnny Cash singing that STD song, don't we?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
we do.
Pretty cool.
Since we're talking about STDs.
As long as it's an STD show. Jimmy Buffett died, by the way. I want y'all to know that. He died last night.
Reset.
Unrelated, surely.
I don't know if he died from an STD. Will you play it, Bobbo?
Go ahead, Bobbo.
It's not working? Okay.
She's going.
Oh, it's not going to work. That's too bad. Well, little fail here this morning. Chris, you're a swinger?
Oh, yes. Hey, I didn't even realize I was on hold still because I'm listening to your radio station because I'm on
the East Coast and you cut off on me.
Right. It, the best way to do it is just go to the YouTube live feed, I think. So tell me about here's your note on the call screen. Went to a swinger website where he had to upload a pic of his junk. They select lovers like that. Okay.
Yep. That's so what you do.
Go ahead.
You have to upload a picture of your face, of course, and that's how you interact with people. And then if you get interested, then they unlock private pics of themselves. And you have to have them most times. They say, no private pics, no talk, blah, blah, blah. And then, it was kind of nerve-wracking because I was a single guy, mid-30s. I was like, oh, I want something to do by myself down here in Orlando. And then once I finally broke the ice and did it, then I can wrap in with the Viagra. I had to get somebody that I could have a steady supply of Viagra on, because then I started actually getting to do it a little bit. But yeah, it was mostly I got messaged by men wanting help with their wives, because I'm a single guy. So that's all I've been with on the swinger website is couples.
So you're a stand-in man. You're a coxman. You're Mr. Ed.
Yeah, but I'm not gay. And the guy would say, I'm not gay. I just want somebody with my wife, you know.
Now, why do people do that? I need to understand this. I mean, this is what you do for a living, it sounds like. So you make love. You breed other people's wives.
Yeah, yep.
Do you charge?
Nope, they don't charge. They're very high-class people, good, have good jobs. We go out to eat before when we first meet up with somebody. I have a few regulars that we deal with it's pleasant.
You're a billy goat walking the neighborhood, not kicking on doors, and they bring you in. And so why do you think men enjoy you bedding their wives?
I think most of the ones that I've been with, they think that it gets a satisfaction because their wives are sexy, and they see that their wives feel that they are sexy and still wanted by other men. Because I kind of like a little older women. I'm mid-30s. Most of them are 44, but they're beautiful women. You know, that's what I like anyways. But that's kind of because then we go out to eat. Maybe we'll have a few drinks and flirt with the wife. Or, oh, you're pretty, you know, this and that. And then, you know, like I said, it was nerve-wracking at first. But now that I've got, it's a whole different lifestyle.
Does the guy ever get mad in the middle of it?
Never had that. Nope. Never had guys get mad. Usually they're very open about it when we're talking about it. Nope. You could seem like, I could see how you would think that.
Do you have any plans for the weekend? Do you have any appointments this weekend? I'm not looking to hire you. I just want to hear more about your story. Like, is this going to happen tonight?
I just got back in from town from my work. And actually there is one of mine that I haven't seen in a while, actually since New Year's. And, they're wanting to kind of get up tonight. It's actually, and I know this don't matter, but it's my first time. It's a white man with his black wife. Very beautiful woman.
So it's your first time to go after a black guy?
No, but she is the first time that I've ever had a black wife with a white husband that wanted that, you know, that they were okay with that.
Did you ever watch the Jeffersons? Did you ever watch the Jeffersons?
A little bit. Were you talking about? No, that's the Jetsons. Maybe a little bit growing up, my dad, a little bit.
Big difference between the Jeffersons and the Jetsons. Yeah. Jeffersons. So Lenny Kravitz, are you a friend of? Are you a fan of Lenny Kravitz?
Oh yeah, I've been playing the guitar since I was 12. So I'm very.
You have, and I'm sure you have. And his mother is Roxy Roker on the Jeffersons, and she's married to Tom, the white guy. So that's who you're meeting up tonight.
Okay.
Have fun. All right, 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. My name is John Clay Wolfe. I'm a little confused, too. If you're confused, I'm with you. The next segment is the car segment where we're going to bid the cars in the lightning round, 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. Call in right now during this song. We'll come back, do the cars, and then we'll get on with it. Be right back. GiveMeTheVIN.com is America's best car buyer for a reason. We don't sell your leads to anyone else like the rest of our competitors. You're our customer. We handle our customers right, and that's why we're America's best car buyer. You're not going to get harassed by a bunch of different people selling your information. GiveMeTheVIN.com dominates. Why? Because we take care of our customers. They don't call me America's best car buyer for nothing.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com. So easy you can do it in your
on the air every Saturday morning.
Houston and broadcasting to the rest of the world online at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com. You're listening to the John Clay Wolfe Show. Want more of the John Clay Wolfe Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com. Now, back to the John Clay Wolfe Show. Hit him up right now, 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
And this is where I quick bid cars for GiveMeTheVIN.com. Wes in Kansas City, you've got a 20 Civic Sport stick shift with 70,000 miles you want $22,000 for. What do you think I'm going to say?
Too high.
Yep, too high, too high. Mark, a 12 F-150 XLT with 140,000 miles, extended cab, long bed. Car's worth $12,000.
Okay. Yeah,
I'll give 12. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, load it up. Scotty, New Orleans, 21 Porsche Cayenne GTS. So it's an 8-cylinder?
That's right.
What color?
White.
That's good. How many miles?
20.
Clean facts?
Oh, yeah.
All right. But it's a lease. We got to buy the lease off. You said Porsche is giving you 87,000?
Yeah, they quoted 87. Essentially, they said, I've got 76 left. They said they cut me a check for 10. Mm-hmm. I'm waiting on my next one to get here, so that's where I stand.
Do you just want to sell it to me? I can do that, but there's not much left after that. Is it easier to sell to me, right, or is it easier to sell to them?
I mean, it's a little easier to sell it to them because I just give it back.
Right. Put me down for plus 1,500, maybe 2,000, so I can knock them off.
Cool. I'm about 3 weeks out. I'll load it up and get back in touch.
Thank you. Thank you. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com. Marcy in Vegas, a 12 Jag with 125,000 miles. It is the big car. It's the XJL portfolio. Is it the supercharged?
No.
Okay. So it's a super, it's just the XJL. Those Jags with high miles, they break down too much and they don't bring the right money. So that car is not worth
it. I'm the original owner and I've done all the maintenance. So it's I haven't had any big problems.
Oh, I hear you. I just have, when I sell it to the market, which I supply dealers, that car is going to bring about $6,000 in the auction lane.
No way.
Yes, yeah, the miles, man. Jaguars, the reputation of Jaguars and high miles. Nobody trusts them. Everybody knows they're ticking time bombs. They won't pay any money for them. If you can lay it down to your neighbor or somebody at your church or somebody that you really want to screw hard that you don't like, sell them for 10. Thank you. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO is the call-in number or text-in number. Podcast goes up at about 2 o'clock today at jcwshow.com. The video stream's there as well. And the audio stream. Check us out on Twitter, John Clay Wolfe. Facebook, The John Clay Wolfe Show. Like us, love us, follow us, all that good stuff. We want to be your friend. We need friends. We don't have any friends. We'll be back in a minute.
Yeah, some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolfe Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
that it's some sort of a happy birthday, John Clay Wolfe. I don't even know how old he's turning.
51, maybe? Yeah, and I remember thinking, wow, he's younger than Frank. That's weird. He seems so much older.
I know.
And leave that in.
Don't ask.
Happy birthday, John Clay Wolfe. Heidi thought you were older than me, but you're just a baby.
Well, because he is so mature and a successful business owner, and you're you.
I know. It seems like I should be way further along in my life because John Clay Wolfe has it down.
But I always look to you, Frank, like I look at you like you're 23, you know? So it's just different.
Yeah, I got stunted.
You definitely did mentally.
John Clay Wolfe got stunted in the brain. He's a 23-year-old brain locked in now, a 50-year-old body.
That's right. Happy birthday, John Clay Wolfe. We love you.
Yeah, I was going to get you something, and I didn't know what to get the man who has everything, so I got you a Kelly Blue Book. Next time you're by, you can pick it up.
It won't Frank, be, I hate, the, I hate
it
to bring
it won't be wrapped
news,
or anything. That's just
I feel
be,
like he has
You think
one.
He has a couple of those? This one's new, though. It's leather.
Oh, it's new. Okay.
Yeah, it's leather.
Kelly's hotter this time.
Yeah, Kelly Blue Ball. Yeah,
picture. Kelly signed it. So, happy birthday, John. Miss you, bud.
We love you.
Come in, hang out again.
Broadcasting live from the Wolfe Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolfe Show. Thanks for making us number one. Damn, it feels good to say that. Call John, toll free, 800-800-RADIO. And check out the podcast at jcwshow.com.
Good morning, Los Angeles. It is Labor Day weekend. This is Guns N' Roses. And you don't want my love, because I'm an ass. If you don't believe me, just ask anybody that knows me. What's the name of this song?
Crazy.
Crazy. Good little Hollywood band right
yes,
down there on
the
strip.
Clean version, Turley. I know you're looking nervous over there.
I can see your friends right now getting ready to party with this song in the background.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they're ready.
They're ready.
Oh, they're ready over there.
I can feel you wanting to maybe switch into party mode yourself.
I just can't. I got to be responsible, but man, they're ready to go.
You're an old partier from way back. You like that environment.
Oh, yeah.
No women. We're out here in perfect. Just abuse your body land. Yeah.
Vodka and Red Bull.
Oh, John, you have an 07 Mustang Shelby Super Snake. I saw this on the board, and I was excited about it until I saw what you wanted for it. I mean, you people and your damn prices. What is wrong with y'all? Y'all see these asking prices from when everybody went crazy with COVID prices, and you're still stuck there. It's like you're stuck in the 80s, man.
It's too damn high.
It's just too high. What'd you pay for it?
All right.
What'd you pay for it?
I bought it about 3 years ago, and I paid $55.
I was going like that. I
said
55.
It, yeah.
I knew you. Now he wants 65. I may bust you out of it. I may bust you out of it, but you ain't making 10 bills off my ass.
Yeah. What'd you offer?
I might get 55. I think 50 was my gut number. It doesn't have 1,400 miles. It has 14,000. There's a difference.
Yeah, no. I've seen the ones with 1,400, and they're asking 100 grand, which is nuts.
Yeah,
but
people are asking a lot. I mean, I've got some stuff I could ask big prices for, too, but I'm not going to sell it because nobody will give it. Anyway, load it up into the website. Go to GiveMeTheVin.com. I am a buyer on it. I've bought about 10 of these. And the last one I did give $65,000 for one in Pittsburgh, and it had 500 miles on it, and I sold it for $65,000. I got the same price. Yeah, yours might not be.
Wow.
Yeah, let me do some current checking, but just go to GiveMeTheVin.com and load it up. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. Crab in Southern California, good morning.
Good morning. Happy weekend and happy birthday. And it's also Heidi and Frank Kramer's birthday this week, Tuesday. Yeah.
Happy birthday,
yep,
Frank. Frank, sure. Frank, if you're. Thanks, hey. Crab. Frank, if you're at the studio, well, we got a minute. Dial in, you can ISDN. We can bang the ball around a little bit and rag on people who don't have cool birthdays like you and I. Amanda, 73 Plymouth Duster. Which engine is in it?
What engine is it? That's a good question. 440 supercharger. Does that make sense? I'm calling on behalf of my brother. So. Uh-huh. I'm sorry if my information is not 100% correct.
Did he make you? Did he think that you could get more money out of me if you called because I'm a sucker for girls?
Yes, okay. Absolutely. And I tell him I listen to the show every Saturday morning. So he's like, well, if you can try it, do it.
Are you saying, are you on KGB in San Diego or 95.5 KLOS in Cal?
We're 95.
Yeah. 95.
I listen to you on the Heidi and Prince show all the time.
Perfect.
I'm a fan.
I love California. I'm a fan. I wasn't, you know, everybody said the California thing would never work, and it's worked great. I've loved you guys, getting to know you. How long have we been out there now? 3.5 years?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we went out like late 2020.
I need to go back. We need to go back soon. Amanda, load it into GiveMeTheVin.com. Let me take a look. Get me some pictures. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks
Send
for calling.
Send me some nudes.
Send me some nudes. 800-800-6. Santa Monica, what you got? You know what we need to do is the, because this is loose and I'm, my hangover is starting to kick in. And I think that if y'all can't tell, I think I ought to have a cocktail.
Yeah.
Do y'all have
you
the
need one.
Are the Bloody Marys up at the house or down here in the studio?
They're up the ball around a little bit.
Hey, Santa Monica, what you got?
Yes, I was wondering if I have a 2015 Camaro convertible.
Okay. How many miles?
To the truth, I'm not even really sure.
Is it like 20 or 80 or I mean, do you have a bulb?
20, more than 20.
Do you know if it's a V8 or V6?
It's a V6.
Okay, what color?
It's red.
Have you ever had intimate relations with a woman?
No, not today.
Okay. And it is it a stick or an automatic?
It's an automatic.
I'm mid-teens, 15, 16, 17. Go to GiveMeTheVin.com, load it up if you want to sell it. Hey, I don't want to do any more car calls. I'm sick of them.
Okay.
But what I will do, you know what I had a blast with last week is when we had the two-minute drill. And it is opening It is opening weekend for football, so I want to do that again. When we go to, how much time do we have in the segment? Oh, perfect. Okay, can I set it up now?
Yeah,
all right.
Do it.
So we're going to stop for a song, and then when you call back, we're going to do the two-minute drill like we did last week. And you call in and you say, I think. Da 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 da. Whatever's on your mind.
I think that, yeah.
Skip the pleasantries. Expect nothing from us at all in response. We're going to, it's almost just like an opportunity for you to make a statement on national radio quickly. Politics, women, Jimmy Buffett's death, anything wild, anything that's on your mind. And we're just going to click through the calls, rapid fire. I think that, like, give us an example, Turley.
I think that TCU is about to lose to Colorado.
Okay. So that would be his. And then we're going to go to the next one. The next one. We did all this right last week, and we had a lot of fun with it. So load the phones up right now. You want to get on the air with us. It's called the two-minute drill. When we come back, we're going to take your calls and just click through them real fast. We'll be right back.
It's Gigi from the John Clay Wolfe Show. Do you want the most money for your used car? Do you want a hassle-free process? Of course you do. Give Me the VIN will beat your written CarMax offer or write you a check for $100. It's that simple. Give Me the VIN is A-plus rated by the BBB and thousands of online reviews. Get an instant cash offer and the most money for your used car right now at GiveMeTheVIN.com. America's best car buyer.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com. So easy you can do it in your
This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Get a haircut, buttercup!
America's largest weekend morning show, 800-800-RADIO. Check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolfe.com. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, the John Clay Wolfe Show.
Hey, Mark, we're dumping you off. I'm done with car calls. Please load it into GiveMeTheVIN.com.
John Clay Wolfe Show, taking over your radio every Saturday morning. Hit him up, 800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolfe Show.
We've got to do Jeopardy, too. And I teased the two-minute drill. Let's do this. Let me show everybody real quick what the two-minute drill is kind of an example of, and then we will do Jeopardy, and then we'll do a big one in a minute. So what we're going to do on the two-minute drill thing is where you say, I think that... Here, we'll just... I'll give you an example right now. Josh, go. West Georgia.
Hey, it's Joshua from Georgia. I think my Bulldogs are their schedule's so weak that they're not going to be ready for the playoffs. Maybe not even the SEC championship, and a Big Ten team's going to stomp them out. Sadly.
Ouch. Dave, Temecula, California, go.
Yeah, I think people should listen to police officers, and they won't get shot.
Ollie in United Kingdom, you're over the pond.
Hiya, John. Yeah, I am. Happy birthday. I think you guys should market yourselves and get over here in the UK because you make my Saturday afternoons. And honestly, the Brits have got a stick up their rear. You guys would lighten it up. Something brilliant. You really should get over here.
Thank you. Hey, go to John Clay Wolfe Show and click email John. Send me a note. I want your number. I want to talk to you off air. Thank you. Luther, Fredericksburg, Virginia, go. Luther in Virginia, you there? You hung up.
So you were doing such great with the examples.
Terry in San Diego, go.
Hi, how you doing? I think that you have the greatest radio show on earth, and who knew the apocalypse would be so expensive?
Thank you. So that's an example. You guys call in. We're going to do Jeopardy right now. We'll do a full 2 minutes of that quick. I think that and make your statement. 800-800-7234. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO is the call-in number. And it is time for Jeopardy. Gigi, biatch, you're going down, down,
whatever,
down.
Whatever. You know what I mean? You did that on purpose.
You don't get to have the cheat. You don't get to cheat. You don't have the answers like you had.
There's no cheat. There's no nothing.
We could do black history and I'd beat you.
Wow. You can't do black anything.
Wow. That is a wow.
Let's go.
All right, let's test the pop culture IQ of our own John Clay Wolfe and his friends Gigi and JD. Yep. And Pre-K's back there, too. If anybody has a random answer, he might get one. Our categories this week, Big Ed, talking about Eddie Murphy at the movies. And Citizens Band, CB Talk. That should be fun. Here's our first category. Ready for question?
Yes.
Question one. Besides being damned funny, Eddie Murphy's first major motion picture literally invented the adventure comedy cop buddy movie.
Ding, 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 ding. What is 48 Hours?
No, no, dumb. You ought to push the button that says dumb.
And I said ding.
Yeah, but it was dumb. What is Beverly Hills Cop?
That's not.
It is 48 Hours.
Actually. Oh, what about the dumb, dumbity, dumb, dumb, dumb? Thank you for my point.
GG's on the board.
I didn't hear the question properly.
For time's sake, here comes question number two. This film wasn't Eddie Murphy's only flop at the box office, but it was the only film where he went on a quest to rescue a magical Asian child.
Got it.
John?
What is Golden Child?
That is correct. Tied up at two. Question three.
Okay, here we go.
This Eddie Murphy film from 1987 was the highest grossing stand-up comedy film in motion picture history. John?
Ding, 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 ding. I got it. What is Raw?
That's correct, Gigi. That is right.
I knew it. I should know.
That is correct, Gigi. All right. Into category two, CB Talk. This is going to be fun. This is CB Radio speak for Where Are You?
Ding, 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 ding.
Gigi?
What's your 411?
J.D. Ryan?
What's your 1020?
What's your 1020?
Black people don't know nothing about good CB buddy radios.
Question
my
two.
My mom had one.
Yeah, when they were calling her to come see him in the evenings.
Hey. Her name was Hot Grits.
I bet they were. I bet that's right.
It was Hot Grits.
Not Dolomite? Question two. What does it mean when your CB buddy says the driver behind him has a black eye?
He's got Hot Grits in the riding shotgun.
That is incorrect. Driving at night, talking to your buddy on the CB, he says, "This driver behind me got a black eye, good buddy."
Ding.
John?
Light out.
That's right.
Hey, look at that. Okay.
Driving with one headlight or a headlight.
So John has two, Gigi has two, JD has one.
Here comes question three. How does one ask on Channel 19 if anyone has seen a highway patrol in the general vicinity?
Ding, 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 ding.
JD?
No, you said it first. Don't you be such stupid.
I did it twice.
Gosh darn. Excuse me. Dump that, will you?
Such an angry man.
It's too late, man.
No, it's not too late.
I forgot the question now.
I've got to quit saying that on the radio.
How does one ask on Channel 19 if anyone has seen a highway patrol in the general vicinity?
Break 19, anybody got an eyes on the Smokey?
Pretty close. I mean, that is correct.
We'll give it to him.
He might have a different version. What was your version?
The textbook terminology would be break 19 for a Smokey report.
Smokey report.
So we're all tied at two, John.
All tied at
Bobo,
two.
What are we going
to
do?
Here's your bonus question back to Eddie Murphy. Eddie's considered big comeback role was a film starring Eddie Murphy as filmmaker Rudy Ray Moore, best known for his
ding, 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 ding
series of exploitation
What is Dolomite?
Mm.
What is Dolomite?
That's not the name of the movie, but you're right. I'm going to give it to you because you're on the right.
Thank you. I'll take it. I'll take it. Just give it to me. I'll take it.
Dolomite is my name.
That's good enough.
And what a great movie. Way to go, Gigi. Wins this week.
Gigi, you won.
Yay, and I didn't even cheat this time.
I know.
You worked hard for the money.
All right, I want to do a couple of two-minute drill people.
Are you going to explain everybody what's going on?
I'm not even going to bother. I'm just going to do it.
So anybody just tuning in, just
2 minute drill. People are just calling in with a quick statement.
I think that you can.
I think that.
Do you have the whistle? Jim, go.
Yes, Jim from Tucson, Arizona. I think we should bring back Aunt Jemima and Uncle Ben Rice.
Gigi, do you agree with him?
I agree 100%.
I think that that was a damn shame. I mean, I'm a friend of Aunt Jemima. I'm a fan of Aunt Jemima. I mean, getting rid of Aunt Jemima is not cool.
She was a real
person.
I mean,
person. It's wrong priorities. What did she do to anybody?
And she had a great story in East Texas starting that restaurant. I mean, that's BS. That's when keeping it, that's when keeping it real goes wrong.
3 minute drill.
Luther.
I think Kevin Spacey should be able to make movies again.
Steve in California.
I think we all ought to give a big shout out to Jimmy Buffett. And go have a margarita.
I think you're right. Isn't that sad? Yeah. I wasn't expecting that one.
Yeah.
Marsha in Louisiana.
Yes, I think January the 6th was a setup, and I think Nancy Pelosi was the head mastermind.
I think you're right.
I think she needs a new phone.
Amen. I've been saying that for so many
Todd
years.
In Royce City.
I think we should have the 2024 Willie Nelson 4th of July picnic at the John Clay Wolfe Boston County Ranch. Yeah. And I want a VIP party.
I wonder if he'll still be alive.
That's what I'm thinking after last night's news, brother.
Yeah, no joke. San Diego, you're on.
I think that Bobo is Satan. What? And if I find out that Bobo is Satan,
Satan.
You just lost the listener.
Wow, man.
Satan is Bobo Satan.
Well, I mean,
we got the Prince of Darkness here.
Don't get me wrong, I do live for your approval. But, you know, I mean, I'm the Prince of Darkness, man. I got to do my own thing. You have no idea what a Saturday for me entails. This is when I wait for him to get over that 11 drink limit and drag him home where we all belong. Hell is beautiful in the late summertime.
Did you take Jimmy Buffett?
No, I couldn't get him. I couldn't get him. He was supposed to call me on Friday.
Jimmy Buffett?
Yeah.
This is the devil, everybody.
I was going to buy his other plane.
Okay.
Yeah, because Clooney's taking flying lessons. I don't know if you heard of it, and I've got like a 2-point deal.
Oh, you do?
Would you, I mean, in my business, would you trade Buffett for Clooney?
That's a tough one.
Of course not.
No.
But... sure deal?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. Clooney in the hand, so Buffett in the bush.
Two Buffets in the bush.
I mean, I'll see him again. I've known Buffett a long time.
Right.
Thank you, Satan. Daniel, go.
Yeah, I think toilet paper is for asswipes.
There you go. Hey,
smart.
I think he's a smart fella in there in Arizona, Daniel is. Don't we have a minute left? Golly.
Well, we do have time to tell people to subscribe and to like our channel on YouTube. By the way, jcwshow.com is where all this stuff is. And we have a YouTube channel. You can watch the whole show. You can see what nice birthday shirt John's wearing today. How old are you again, Johnny?
51.
51.
51.
Big party begins in
maybe
about...
maybe go get that big butt check we were talking about.
Half a 102.
Have you ever... you haven't done that, John? You haven't done the colonoscopy? Well, I've had three of them.
I've tried to get myself one a couple times.
No, well, that's, I had a girlfriend that used to do that. But anyway, yeah. Different story.
Good different story Lord. For different
did I just
times.
Get dumped? No.
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 All right. JCWShow.com is all the goodies. And, of course, the show goes up in a little bit. And the please do like and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
800-800-7234. We're losing most of you guys. Denver, we're going to lose you. You can jump over at the stream at JCW Show. West Coast Hour is next. And happy Memorial Day. Not Memorial Day.
Labor Day.
And God love you, Jimmy Buffett. We hate that you're gone so quick. Be right back. Somebody sound the alarm. I'd like to go where the pace of life's slow. Could you meet me somewhere, Mr. Scott? Any old place here on earth or in space. You think the century.
The John Clay Wolfe Show is heard every week on great stations. Catch the nation's fastest growing podcast and live video stream at johnclaywolfe.com.